and welcome back once again, everyone, to Joe Louis Arena. We apologize for the technical difficulties. No audio. Well, it was actually leaving the arena here, but it was not reaching your home. John Saunders here along with Mike Milbury and Barry Melrose. Let's get right to it. Talk about these teams. New Jersey, a great defensive squad.
That is exactly right, John. It's their trademark. It starts with big, strong forwards. They play the trap in the neutral zone. You can't get through it. You can't penetrate. Then it's backed up by big, strong, experienced defensemen. And finally, one of the best goaltenders in hockey in Martin Brodeur. But they can score some goals as well. And speaking of goal scoring, Barry, this is the team right here that can do it in Detroit.
Yeah, Mike, it's a great offense fueled by talent and speed. They've got an offense that punishes you. If you make a mistake, they'll score against you. They've also got a defense that moves the puck very well, which helps their transition game.
All right, we're only a few minutes away from dropping the first puck in the first faceoff. So for more on the series, let's join Al Morganti.
Well, the question this morning was Dino Ciccarelli. He wasn't on the ice, not in the warm-up. Would it be a calamity? No, just kind of chilling out. Didn't skate in the morning skate. He'll be there to get interfere with Martin Brodeur or whatever. A big change in the Detroit lineup. Mark Howe will be in the lineup instead of Mike Ramsey. Detroit thinks they have an advantage. They have a more fluid, more mobile defense, and Howe even more fluid. Also, Stu Grimson in the lineup. A little muscle for Detroit on a league level. This is the first finals in 17 years. Andy Van Helleman won't work. And now over to the Jersey bench, maybe trapped on that bench, Steve Levy.
Al, thanks very much. To a man, the Devils said when the puck dropped, there would be nerves, a case of the butterflies, except for one man, Bruce Driver, the best two-way defenseman for New Jersey, said he was actually more nervous this past Tuesday night for Game 6 when the Devils knocked out the Flyers because he couldn't play in that game. He's been injured the last three playoff games. Not so nervous tonight because he will play and will be able to have an impact. Now, we talk so much about how the first goal is important. How about the first shot on goal for a young goaltender like Martin Brodeur? I asked him about that. He said it's not really a problem because the way the guys are playing in front of him, he might not see that first shot for the first 19 minutes of this hockey game. A loose bunch of the Devils. Let's go back upstairs to John.
All right, Stephen Al, thank you very much. The good news is we are hearing you just fine. The bad news is we only have a few minutes left in the show, so we'll get back to Joe Louis Arena in just a moment. And welcome back once again to Joe Louis Arena. Yes, Stevie Yzerman. It took him his entire career to get here, but he has finally arrived. And Scott Stevens, likewise, making it to the Stanley Cup Final. And we're just moments away from game number one. Mike, let's start off by talking about the New Jersey Devils.
This is a potent lineup. It really is exceptional. They've got a great group of power forwards. Right down the line, this team can do an awful lot of things. Guys like Mike Peluso is always looking for action. You also got a guy like Billy Guerin who put a lot of heavy hits out in this series. And also a guy like Claude Lemieux. He's been doing everything, and he's not afraid. But a guy like McKay, noted for his fisticuffs, he can score goals as well. Speaking of Lemieux again, this guy is Mr. Everything. 11 goals in the playoffs. That's more than anybody. And they can play defense. Experience, deep, drivers, terrific. Stevens was all over Eric Lindros. He pinned him all over the place. Lindros really had no break when Danico was on the ice. And when they got through, finally, there was Martin Brodeur. He was terrific in every series when he had to be. Experienced far beyond his years, John.
One of the things that makes this team so valuable and so good at this is their size. They're all like condors. They've all got huge wingspans in the neutral zone.
All right, you talk about the Detroit Red Wings. Everybody thinks offense, but this is a two-way team as well.
They've made a lot of changes this year at the trading deadline. They got Mike Ramsey, a veteran defenseman. They brought in Bob Rouse as a free agent. They went out and got Fedosov at the deadline. This is a team that can play defense. Rouse stands up in the middle. Paul Coffey's playing the best hockey he's played in 5 or 6 years defensively. Konstantinov turned into a force defensively, standing up offensively, a big goal against Chicago, probably the last nail in the coffin. Great defense. Special teams, Coffey leading the power play, which I think right now is the best in hockey. Ciccarelli in front, very dangerous. Keith Primo on the second unit. Kozlov on the second unit. Lidstrom, great player. Big, strong men. Primo showing his dominance. Ciccarelli goes to net. Good shot. Primo again. Great big man. Big force for them right now. And behind them, the goaltender they went out and got in the offseason to finish this team, Mike Vernon. Great glove hand. Veteran goaltender. He's been here before. This team is going to be very, very tough to beat.
I think what they have to do is get their power forwards, New Jersey's power forwards, on the Detroit defense. Lay a little body on them. Punish guys like Coffey and Lidstrom and see where it leads.
It would be very easy to say that this was strictly a team of good defense against one of good offense, but it's much more than that. So for more insight, let's join Bill Clement.
Well, John, it's been kind of fun walking around here, seeing people trying to get a feel for this series and handicap it. And the reason we are all having trouble is these two teams have not faced each other yet this year. Because of the lockout shortened season, West did not play East. I think if you were going to paint this series in broad strokes, it would be Detroit's talent against the Devils' system. Now, both teams have good defensive systems. The Red Wings have three men always backing up in the neutral zone. They let you come at them, but they take away all of the odd man rushes. You don't get breakaways against them. You don't get two-on-ones. The Devils, on the other hand, use a five-man trap. They channel the play to one side. They kind of surround the puck carrier, take away all the passing lanes, and force turnovers that way. I think that Devils trap is the one that has to be solved by the Red Wings. If the Red Wings do not do it in Game 1, they might find themselves going back to the Meadowlands for Game 3, down 2-0 the way the Flyers did against the Devils. If the Red Wings do solve the trap, however, in Game 1, I think it'll be a quick series with Detroit winning. Guys?
It is indeed a tough one to call, and Steve Levy is still, as we said before, trapped on the Devils' bench. Steve?
John, I'll tell you what, the Devils are ready to go. One way of telling that, assistant coach Larry Robinson had to come out on the ice during the skate this afternoon and actually physically remove some of his starters, so they're really ready to go. As far as the attention, the Devils playing up this underdog thing as if they needed extra motivation, all the stars on the Detroit side, the marquee names, Bill Guerin of the Devils said that yesterday's press conference, he could have sat there naked and no one would have noticed. Maybe a bit of an exaggeration. Let's go back to Al.
Thanks, Steve. The feeling with Detroit, especially from Steve Yzerman, finally we're here. Finally on a couple of levels. Finally, for all the years Detroit was supposed to have such great teams and didn't get here. Also, finally, the wait is over after winning their last series. Each guy I went to said, hey, we know there's going to be butterflies. Mike Vernon said, you're only human to have butterflies, but they want to get this thing done, get on the ice, get rid of the butterflies, and start with the Devils. John?
All right, Al, thanks a lot, guys. We've said it so many times. These two teams have not met during the regular season because of the lockout. How do you see the series going?
I see the first period as a real strong feel-out period here. Both teams trying to find how strong they are, how the opponents stack up in terms of speed. And it really will be interesting in the first 10 minutes. I always like the team that draws first blood in Game 1, Barry.
Well, I like the fact that they haven't played each other. Detroit is totally different than Philadelphia. They're faster. They're smaller. They got to rely on their quickness. They've got a defense that moves the puck very well. They got defensemen like Coffey and Liston to jump into the play. Philadelphia didn't do that, so that's going to be different for the Devils. And this is a big test for Vernon. He hasn't had success for the last 4 or 5 years. So how Mike Vernon plays is going to be a big key for Detroit.
Who's the winner?
Well, I said it back in October, John. I'll go with it now. I think New Jersey will win this game, this series, in six or less, but it won't be without a struggle.
Well, I said this back in August, and I got to pick Jersey in six. They're a great team, and they don't have many weaknesses, but I think the two best teams in hockey are playing tonight.
Back in 75, when they were still the Kansas City Scouts, I thought this team had a chance to win 20 years later. But we want to remind you, we will have Game 2 for you here on ESPN. It begins at 7:30 Eastern Time with the quest for the Cup. Then 8 o'clock Eastern Time, will the Devils or the Red Wings be up 1-0? We'll find out in just a few moments' time. We'll see it Tuesday night. Right now, from Joe Louis Arena, good night, everyone.
Rest of the NHL, it's cup time for the Wings and Devils. Game 1 of the Stanley Cup Finals on Fox. The last time Detroit was in the finals, the Temptations were top of the charts. Red Wings fans ain't too proud to beg. Okay, it's been a while since Motown's 55 Cup, but what's the deal with all that octopi? And as for them Devils, they're making their first trip to the finals. Jersey came oh so close last year, but almost only counts in horseshoes. And hand grenades. Detroit's got the firepower to win it all. They went 5 games with the Hawks, but it felt more like 7. After 5 OT periods with Chicago, them Wings had everything thrown at them, including the kitchen sink. New Jersey trapped the Doom into surrendering. Now they're packing that D for the Motor City, primed to shut down that Detroit engine. Can Lemieux continue his postseason explosion? Will there be a coffee cup with the number 5 on it? And Yzerman and Fedorov, they'll be doing just fine with 1. All right, boys, button your chin straps, because this is it.
Okay, ready to go?
Yeah.
Let's get it on!
Red Wings have last had the chance to win the Stanley Cup in 40 years since they won it. Well, folks, the fans here are fired up, and guess what? So are we, as for the first time in more than two decades, the Stanley Cup Finals come to network primetime. Good evening, everyone, and welcome. I'm James Brown, along with my partner Dave Maloney at a fired-up Joe Louis Arena. This excitement, is it akin to your final that you played in 79?
Well, let me tell you something, JB. In 79, Game 3, Billy Joel singing the national anthem at Madison Square Garden. I was so fired up, I gave him a whack in the behind. I don't think he's been the same since. It's cup time.
And I know he hasn't forgotten you either. Hey, congratulations are in order. This guy said this would be the matchup for the finals back at the beginning of the playoffs. A shortened season, intra-conference play. These two squads haven't met during the regular season.
That's a good point, and it's a documented point. The point is, though, because they haven't seen it, tactically doesn't mean anything. We know about the trap. We know how fast Detroit skates. What we don't know is what kind of anger they're going to play with. They haven't seen one another. It's like the Cowboys and the 49ers. The more they play, the more they hate one another. This is going to be good in games two and three.
Since you play the part of clairvoyant, let me ask you, what does the outcome of this series hinge on?
I think the outcome is if the Devils can establish a presence in the offensive zone, it's up to Cole Caulfield, get the puck to the forwards. I like the Wings in seven.
All right, most people agree that the Wings are the more talented team, but don't count out those Devils. Hey, folks, we've got a lot more coming your way. We'll be back with the starting lineups for the Red Wings and the Devils as Fox's coverage of the Stanley Cup Finals continues after this. Respect for tradition is very important to the Red Wings, and so is the voice that's been associated with this organization for more than 45 years. For the starting lineups of both teams, let's take it to the PA announcer, Bud Lynch.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 1995 Eastern Conference champions, the New Jersey Devils. On defense, number 3, Ken Danico. On defense, number 6, Tommy Ebeline. Left wing, number 8, Mike Peluso. At center, number 9, Neil Broughton. At right wing, number 12, Bill Guerin. At right wing, number 15, John McClain. At center, number 16, Bobby Holdick. At right wing, number 17, Tom Chorsky. At center, number 18, Sergei Breland. At center, number 19, Bob Carpenter. At right wing, number 21, Randy McKay. At right wing, number 22, Claude Lemieux. At defense, number 23, Bruce Driver. At left wing, number 25, Valerie Zalapukin. Defense number 27, Scott Niedermeyer. On defense number 29, Sean Chambers. Left wing number 44, Stephane Richer. Goalkeeper number 31, Chris Terreri. In goal number 30, Marte Brodeur. On defense, number 4, Captain Scott Stevens. And the assistant coaches, Larry Robinson, Jacques Caron, Dennis Gendron, the head coach, Jacques Lemaire. And now, 1995 Western Conference champions, the Detroit Red Wings. On defense, number three, Bob Rose. On defense, number four, Mark Howe. On defense, number five, Nicklas Lidström. Left wing, number 11, Sean Murr. Left wing, number 13, Vyacheslav Kozlov. On defense, number 16, Vladimir Konstantinov. Right wing, number 17, Doug Brown. Left wing, number 21, Bob Airy. Right wing, number 22, Dino Ciccarelli. Right wing, number 25, Darren McCurdy. Right wing, number 26, Ray Shepard. Left wing, number 32, Stu Grimson. Center, number 33, Chris Draper. On defense, number 44, Vyacheslav Fetisov. At center, number 55, Keith Primo. On defense, number 77, Paul Coffey. Center number 91, Sergei Fedorov. Goalkeeper number 30, Chris Osgood. Goalkeeper number 29, Mike Vernon. At center, the captain, number 19, Steve Eiserman. Assistant coaches, Dave Lewis, Barry Smith, the head coach, Scotty Bowman. Now, ladies and gentlemen, will you please rise? The U.S. National Anthem, tonight's vocalist, the Red Wings' own Karen Newman.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, Spangled banner yet wave.
The teams have been introduced. The national anthem has been sung. The only thing that's left is to send it up to the guys who will be calling tonight's game, Dr. Mike Emmert and John Davison. Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening. What an electric atmosphere here at sold-out Joe Louis Arena in Detroit, and why not? You've got the best defense in the playoffs, New Jersey, against the best offense in Detroit, and the deepest offense, too, with the Red Wings.
I think, Mike, when you look at this Detroit Hockey Club, they may be the deepest team at the center ice position of all teams in hockey today. We're talking about Fedorov, Yzerman, and a big guy, Primo. So it's tough for the Devils to just key on one line. Now, if you stop their forwards, then you got to worry about Paul Coffey. The future Hall of Fame defenseman's been awesome. This Detroit team has 13 Stanley Cup rings amongst the club. He's got three of them. He's looking for his fourth.
When you consider the offense that Detroit has, how does New Jersey ever stop it?
Well, they play the trap and counter game, and they're very good at it. You think about Claude Lemieux, 11 goals, leads all playoff performers thus far. You know, he played against Boston, he played against Cam Neely, and he scored goals. We're talking about Lemieux. He played against Pittsburgh. The Devils beat them, and he scored goals against Ron Francis and the great Jaromir Jagr. Played against Philadelphia and beat the Flyers, and he scored the goals against Eric Lindros. So when you think about the Devils, they're going to try to trap and counter to get their offense. Detroit says, we're going to beat you with speed. Let's see if they can trap the Red Wings. They're pretty fast.
Bartan Brodeur, 23, has started every game for his team. Best average in the playoffs, and he has never faced Detroit. At the other end of the ice, it'll be Mike Vernon, 32 years of age, has started every game for his team. Second best average in the playoffs. He hasn't faced the New Jersey Devils in 4 years, and that team has changed a lot in that time. The field of 59 officials is down to just seven now. That's based on merit tonight. Bill McCreary, Brian Murphy, and Kevin Collins. Terry Gregson and Wayne Bonney, the standbys. The off-ice officials are from Toronto and downstairs to Joe Micheletti.
Okay, Mike, thanks very much. The tradition began in 1952 of throwing the octopus on the ice, the eight tentacles symbolic of the number of playoff wins to win the Stanley Cup. But things have changed here in Detroit. A lot of people are thinking that the tradition is getting too old. It's time to move on. In one fish market, they're giving away the octopus by showing a ticket for tonight's game, and Steve Yzerman wants everything to end. Well, folks, here's my vote that the tradition ends tonight.
I would guess so.
Ooh.
How do you handicap a blind date, John?
They haven't played against each other all season long. Two great coaches, Jacques Lemaire with New Jersey, Scotty Bowman with Detroit. Both have had control of their teams for two seasons. Both have total control of their players. Let's see what type of matchups they go with. They start Broughton against Fedorov. Here we go.
Broughton, McLean, and Chorsky for New Jersey. Stevens and Chambers. Doug Brown, Fedorov, and Kozlov for Detroit with Rouse and Fetisov. Scott Stevens, the captain of New Jersey. That tap, but taken by John McClain. Right back to him, but he flexed it back in. And Mike Vernon allows this one to go. Chorsky got there, but the icing touch-up comes.
Slava Fetisov, a former New Jersey Devil, was traded to the Detroit Red Wings prior to the trade deadline during this past hockey season. He was brought into head coach Scotty Bowman's office, and they spent a good deal of time going over New Jersey, each player, each system that the Devils employ on the ice. In fact, Scotty Bowman, whom you're looking at, called the hockey world. He called everybody he knew how to beat the trap, how to beat the Devils, what to look for with tendencies of their players.
Fetisov took the hit and rolled it around behind. Fedorov couldn't get it there. Broughton could. And along to Chorsky. He's able to pitch it along, but it's kept alive by Kozlov and handed over to Slava Fetisov. Handed quickly to Fedorov. On across. Kozlov couldn't get a shot away because of Stevens. Now it's taken by Doug Brown, the ex-Devil. Chipped over to Fedorov. Sergei Fedorov controlling and firing one that's blocked aside. And it'll be the Devils to take over in the person of Tom Chorsky. Chorsky out of the University of Minnesota just popped it back in the first shift change of the game for New Jersey as Detroit brings it back. Kozlov shaking it on ahead for Darren McCarty. McCarty locks up in the corner with Tommy Alvelin on the defense. Puck picked up by Yzerman, and the captain for Detroit couldn't get to the front. Now it's Airy. Rammed by Niedermeyer, but he got it behind McCarty there. There were three Red Wings behind the net at once. Airy along now for Yzerman, who turns. Yzerman back behind for McCarty. Carpenter on him. would be Carpenter, able to knock it away. Veteran defensive-minded centerman out of Beverly, Massachusetts, threw it back down and on Mike Vernon.
You can see Detroit feeling good, handling the puck well, getting into the offensive zone, but this defensive New Jersey club, well-schooled in team defense, not giving up anything of quality yet.
Sean Burr got it over to Keith Primo, then to Paul Coffey, but knocked away from him by Richer, and Coffey taken hard to the glass. Now Bobby Holík is back, and it's 2-on-1, he fires! Oh, and Vernon came up with it, and then it popped loose, but the whistle had blown.
Bobby Carpenter for the Devils went off the ice. Holík replaced him, had the first good scoring chance of this series, and Mike Vernon, who stands up, plays angles well, did the good job in making the save. There you see the Devils. Holík, it's a 2-on-1, he took the shot. You see the winger come in looking for the rebound. There was a quick whistle as Bill McCreary lost sight of the puck. You see the man on the left side driving to the net. There's the shot. It rattles between the legs of Vernon. He's not sure where it is. And Niedermeyer, the defenseman, nearly got the rebound.
New Jersey has a line they assembled in mid-year last season called the Crash Line. All of these guys are big. They all hit. And you'll see examples here. Mike Peluso, former Chicago Blackhawk on left wing. On the right wing, Randy McKay, an ex-Red Wing, and Bobby Holík, who tried to dance by the defense there, is the centerman. And bodies normally go flying when they're playing. Ray Shepard got it back on for Chris Draper. Lays it on for Stu Grimson, a tough man in his own right. It's not booing. You hear the Stu chant go up whenever he handles the puck. He's number 32 in white. Now it's brought on by Mike Peluso, given to Bruce Driver. Driver, who missed the last three games because of a back injury, is back in the lineup for the first of these finals tonight.
Driver had wrenched his back in a knot of muscle for him as the muscles were trying to tell his body that there was a problem, but it's calmed down. He's been able to practice. You can see he's able to shoot the puck, and he's united with Ken Danico. It's interesting, the Devils have broken the defense pairing of Scott Stevens and Ken Danico, who played against Eric Lindros, and every time that line for Philadelphia was on the ice. Stevens now on the ice with Sean Chambers. So the Devils, a hockey club led by that man, Jacques Lemaire, a team that can adjust all over the place with each game, with each period, with each shift, whatever they need to do.
If Jacques Lemaire wins a championship with New Jersey, he'll be the third former player for Scotty Bowman to coach a Stanley Cup champion. Al Arbor and Terry Crisp, the other two. Puck floated in away from Brodeur, thrown by McCarty off Brodeur. Loose puck poked along now for Sergei Breland. Out of Moscow, Russia. Breland with a pass that's off Bill Guerin. Swung right back in. And Chambers rolls it behind. And along for Guerin. Rammed by Bob Airey. And knocked flying was Breland by McCarty. Airey comes up with it. Airey tried to get it in front. Knocked down and thrown away by Breland. Kept alive by Lidstrom. Set back up for Eiserman, who shot one. And that ricocheted back out. 3 minutes, 10 seconds have been played in the first period. And both teams with a shot. Eiserman couldn't take that pass. Paul Coffey threw it back in and then took the obligatory hit from Bill Guerin. If you were to ask the Devils about this shot total right now, I think they'd be happy with this 1-1 because you expect Detroit to come at you in waves. No score. Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Thirty-fourth consecutive playoff sellout here at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit, extending back to April of 1988. They love their hockey here, and they have supported this team in some years when they didn't even make the playoffs.
This is without a doubt one of the great hockey cities in North America. For this faceoff, Sean Burr took the faceoff and not the centerman, Keith Primo.
It's the same line that the Devils had out to start this game. Corky in the play in the wingers for Neil Broughton. Broughton battling now along the wall. Neil Broughton, a member of the 1980 gold medal U.S. Olympic team. Petisoff over, Rouse with a shot, blocked right out by Brodeur. And flung back down. Rouse going for the icing touch-up.
It's a third or fourth icing in the period by New Jersey. Whenever they find themselves getting into any form of trouble, they move the puck down the ice and then collect themselves and prepare themselves for their own zone. Scotty Bowman said, when you think about New Jersey, you have to respect their speed. Nobody talks about it. But we know they play that web of a trap in the neutral zone to create the turnovers. We're going to try and beat it with speed. We're going to try and beat them with speed. You can't trap what you can't catch. Scotty Bowman coached in Montreal, won Stanley Cups, four in a row in the 70s, and one of his best players was the head coach, Jacques Lemaire, of the New Jersey Devils.
Jacques was there for all five of the ones that Bowman coached, and Jacques had three others. So a total of eight. Puck to the point, and Fetisov shot ricocheted off Randy McKay and back. Rouse drives it back in, eludes the stick of Brodeur. Doug Brown helped it along. Kozlov shot turned aside by Brodeur. Centering pass and a beauty by Fetisov, cut off by Driver, and around now for Claude Lemieux. And Rouse, and then he's plastered by Bobby Holik. Claude Lemieux, leading scorer in these playoffs with 11 goals, rolling it back in. And it's Fetisov, his former teammate, taking it away from him. Fetisov lost to Richer. Flipped one in front that's guided away by the now helmetless Rouse and taken by Niedermeyer. It's Kozlov taking it over. But now Brodeur. And offside. The puck must be the first thing to cross that line if you're attacking. In that case, it had been, but was thrown back out and brought in early.
I think two of the different styles we may see here. Detroit's defense will try to keep the puck in when New Jersey tries to come up the wings. In other words, that's called a pinch. They'll pinch in at the blue line to keep the puck in. New Jersey's defensemen don't do it, and they haven't had a chance to here so far in the first period, as the puck has been kept in the Devils' zone. But again, the Devils defensively have not given anything up whatsoever.
Two shots for Detroit, one shot for New Jersey. Nearly 4:45 has been played. And it is Stephane Richer up with it. Bangs it back off, hoping for Claude Lemieux. And Lemieux just pitched it back out. Vladimir Konstantinov, one of the many heroes of the Chicago series, who had a double overtime goal. Howe with a pass that misfired and went down. Martin Brodeur slugs it on, and Peluso chipped it back out. Konstantinov chasing it down on defense, and Holik on him. Detroit rolling it ahead. Chris Draper bringing it on. Matched by Bruce Driver, but then he pulls away. Here's Draper wanting a wraparound and didn't get it. Without a stick was Randy McKay, and he retrieves it.
New Jersey changed on the fly to get the matchup they wanted. They wanted the Holik line out here against the big player Primo. Two big centermen, big players. Primo at times can play the wing or center ice. Scotty Bowman will juggle his lines more, I think, than will Jacques Lemaire.
Holik with a shot that went wide. Both teams with 12 wins in three rugged fire best of seven series. The Red Wings had two more days of rest. Their series ended last Sunday. Actually, Monday morning because of double overtime. Here's Airy trying to get through and can't. But all of this brought back on an offside. 14:03 to go in the first period, and we have no score.
210 pounds, Primo into Peluso, who weighs 200 pounds himself. And Peluso with a little message as the parted the hitter in talking about Primo.
In average size, the defense almost exactly the same in inches and in pounds. But the Devils have a 1-inch advantage and a 7-pound advantage when it comes to the forwards. And a lot of it has to do with the crash line. That is not the unit out there right now. Jacques Lemaire is going with Bill Guerin with the puck on right wing. Sergei Breland, who had it for a moment, number 18 in red, the centerman. And the other winger is now Tom Chorsky. Vernon with a faulty handle, but there to help with coffee. And along now to Dino Ciccarelli. Ciccarelli on back to Nicholas Lidstrom. Penalty coming up. It'll be against New Jersey. The Devils touch. And the first power play of the game will be coming up. Elapsed time in the period, 6:47, but no score. Bill Guerin, a holding penalty at 6:47, and Dino will get a chance to go out on the power play. Earlier in the playoffs, he had a power play hat trick.
That was Dino who drew the penalty, which he does a lot of. Bill Guerin came off the bench, hit Dino, got called for holding. Dino Ciccarelli has scored 5 power play goals in the playoffs to this point. There's Ciccarelli. The play's been made, and Guerin made sure he finished Ciccarelli with a hit, but it was well after the puck was moved. So the Detroit power play goes to work, and the key is Coffey. He's the artist on this power play.
And here he is. Coffey flipped it across, but it's tipped to the seats by Driver.
Smart play. Detroit, if they control faceoffs on the power play, they become dangerous immediately. There's the referee, Bill McCreary, talking to Ciccarelli right now, and he's talking about being near the goaltender and the goal crease. Brodeur will see a lot of Ciccarelli in the series. Ciccarelli will camp right near the goal crease, and if there's any goalie interference whatsoever, McCreary's warned Ciccarelli, we just saw it, that he'll go right to the penalty box.
Ciccarelli Fedorov and Yzerman, the three up front, and back it's Coffey, gives it over for the shot by Fedorov that's wide, taken by Nicklas Lidström. His pass blocked on, but back to Coffey, one-timer, went off a devil stick and hit the glass. It is Fedorov, trying to get it along to Ciccarelli. Fedorov again, to the back, Lidström to Coffey. Flips one, that is blocked away by Ken Danico, the veteran defenseman. Couldn't get it out. It's Coffey to Lidström, then back across. Finessed over to Yzerman. Can't control. Rushed to the corner by McLean. Danico flips. Can't get it out. Paul Coffey battles there with Neil Broughton, and they nudge it back as far as center ice. Still the battle on. John McLean came by and gave a shove to Fedorov, but here's Ciccarelli giving it across. Yzerman a shot. Oh, and he squirts one. That went up into the seats.
Faceoff, if it's inside and Bill McCurry says yes, that means that Brodeur made the save. If it hit the crossbar, went into the stands, the faceoff would be outside. So Brodeur with the big save. Ciccarelli drew the penalty, and watch here. He slides out of traffic with the puck and sets up the 2-on-1 shot. Brodeur gets a real good position for the slap shot. Oh, man. That was deflected up high by the defenseman and off the crossbar. Never hit Brodeur. Went right over his shoulder. Bang, off the crossbar. It was deflected off the Devils defenseman way up high at the point of the shot. Wow. Close, close play, and you see this Detroit power play. It is dangerous.
Mark Howe, 40 years of age, who was born just a month after the last time that Detroit won the championship. And his father was on the team, Gordie Howe, and he's here watching tonight. Mark Howe, number four, going back to take it.
I wonder if you will ever see a 40-year-old in the National Hockey League playing in the finals again. I don't know if it'll ever happen again.
Why is that?
Longevity is hard to accomplish in this day and age. The players are bigger. Your body takes a bigger beating. I just don't know if you'll last that long. This is a big story, having a 40-year-old such as Howe playing in the Stanley Cup Final.
He has been plagued by back problems since his days in Philadelphia. 1987 was the first we started hearing about it. And it has been a lot of partial seasons. But what tremendous skill and stick handling and speed he still has at 40.
Been to the big dance twice, and never won the cup.
2 seconds and one, and Bill Guerin is out of the box. Puck played by a high stick, and so a stoppage of play. With 11:13 to go in the first, and you have to think that the Devils have got to be happy with this right now, because if you're anticipating Detroit, you're anticipating offense coming at you in waves.
Well, I would think to this point, Detroit's had the puck 65-70% of the time, and we've played nearly 9 minutes, yet the Red Wings only have 2 shots on goal. One of them, actually none of them on the power play, I don't think, got through to Brodeur. The Devils had the puck in their zone a lot, but they read the diagonal pass. They never gave Detroit a chance to really set up with time with the aggressive penalty kill. And I would think that to this point, you're right, the Devils have to be happy. They haven't given anything up. Now they can maybe get into their game mode. And will Detroit become a team that loses their patience if they don't get offense?
51 seconds of attack time, according to Pat Summers, our statistician here. 51 seconds out of the 2 minutes of attack time. And no shots on goal by Detroit on that power play. Albelin back for an icing touch-up, and play stopped once more. No score in the game. 2 shots for Detroit, 1 for New Jersey. So, nearly 9 minutes played in this first period. And an offensive zone face-off for New Jersey. Rehlin and Yzerman tie up. Poke to Zelepukin. Backhander out in front. Guerin turns around. It's a shot by Chambers that's saved by Vernon. Yzerman turning it along, and then to McCarty. Crisply on to Bob Aaron.
That was a tough save. Vernon had the puck deflect off Zelepukin in front. He's had 2 shots by the Devils and both good ones.
Guerin went across two lines and not by much.
What a play that was. Yzerman, the centerman, filled in on left wing, and he moved in deep. Usually, Detroit keeps their left wing way back. Guerin, who says he was not offside, was up waiting for the puck, and with his speed, he was an inch or two away from the breakaway. Vernon made a key save, only a second shot here in the first period. Look at Zelepukin in front, tripped up, but the concentration. Look at his eyes, follow the puck, off his stick and into the goal pad. Vernon stayed with it. That's a terrific save on a deflection.
Scotty Bowman added a lot of defensemen this year, veteran free agents. He made 7 additions to the club, all of them 30 years old or better. But this is the most significant one that's gotten them here, where in prior years they failed, and that's a strong goaltender in Mike Vernon.
General managers love to get the young players. Coaches love to get the older, experienced players for the playoffs.
Albeline hurried one, but it sped back out, though, right to Tommy Albeline by Arium. He cranks it back in. Teams often think of first periods on the road in terms of 10-minute segments, and they're especially concerned about the first 10. Arium, shot, got the glass. The first 10 for New Jersey, almost over. Bouncing puck, though. Arium, unable to come up with it. It's Sean Chambers. And Bobby Carpenter flips it back in. And the 10-minute mark has been hit. The two teams have 2 shots apiece. Mark Howe gives on over to Keith Primo. Burr hurries it in. Primo tries to pull his way to it. Brodeur flings it around. Knocked down by Mike Peluso. Kept alive by Mark Howe. Into the glove of Driver. And then across for Randy McKay. McKay forced further. Off the glove of Konstantinov. A hand pass ruled by Detroit. New Jersey is trying to be the first team to win a championship, opening all 4 of its playoff rounds on the road. They won the first 2 in Boston. They won 1 of the first 2 in Pittsburgh. They won the first 2 in Philadelphia, and that made a huge difference in eventually getting this far. They have won 8 out of 9 road games.
And here in the first period, past the midpoint of the first period, the shots on goal 2 apiece. And I think you're going to see, if this continues, the people here in Detroit say, we want more from our team. Let's explode with offense. The Devils want that, because if Detroit becomes impatient, this Devil team will counter and get offense by being overly patient.
The Devils really want a lot of respect, too. Don't feel they've gotten.
I think they have from the Detroit Hockey Club and their coaches and players. But around Detroit, the fans are so enamored with their club, and so they should, but nobody seems to mention this Devils club and how good they are and what they're all about. And this is a very well coached, disciplined hockey club.
It is Mark Howe, and kept alive by Bobby Carpenter. Lemieux hit by Konstantinov. Richer came by, but Howe swept it from him. Scott Stevens waits and fires. Hit a skate in front. It was the skate of Claude Lemieux. There'll be a penalty coming up, and this one will be against Detroit. We'll be back with the New Jersey Power Play in just a moment.
We're scoreless. Now here's a one-on-one battle, Lemieux and Konstantinov. Watch Lemieux end up with Konstantinov. Konstantinov loses his stick. Now Lemieux will stay with him and work him, hoping Konstantinov will use his hands to grab Lemieux. Lemieux goes to the front of the net, and sure enough, it happens. Konstantinov, when the puck was there, grabbed the stick of Claude Lemieux, so it's a Devil's power play.
Niedermeyer to Stevens, shoots one, and that one blocked down. Getting in the way of that was Doug Brown, around behind now. McKay flips it over to Richer. Pass is off Fedorov. Hurried by Niedermeyer, deflected wide by Randy McKay. Picked up, though, by Neil Broughton. Broughton just waiting, double-teamed there. Neil Broughton trying to get through Paul Coffey, can't do it, but the puck skipped on to McKay, then behind to Richer. Richer flew one back for Scott Stevens. Able to flip it on for Richer, but it's given up to Coffey. Put it in traffic, but it's drilled back out of play by Doug Brown. Looked like it went near the Detroit bench and maybe off someone, but apparently not.
40-second shift for the penalty killers. Detroit makes a change of all 4 players simply because they're so aggressive with their penalty killers.
The power play in the regular season for New Jersey was an embarrassment, about 80%. It has been 90% in the playoffs. They've really stepped it up. Puck on back to Niedermeyer. Shoots! Ricocheted in front. Bill Guerin couldn't get a shot away. Denied by Fetisov, and it's turned on now to Steve Yzerman. Yzerman tucked a pass through. Bob Airey tried to get by and could not. Solid defensive play by Stevens. On now to Guerin. Hurries it up to John McClain. McClain trying to get by Fetisov. Can't do it yet. And they cancel. To the last 40 of the man advantage, and play stopped.
Mike, in watching this Detroit Hockey Club kill the penalties, watch the forwards right here and here. They're going to drop all the way back and take care of right in front of the net. Now here's a 2-on-1 on Broughton, the centerman who has the puck along the boards. Now Detroit, you see them all move back? Okay, now we stop it there. Look at this. They're all back there. They don't care about this defenseman or that one. They want to take care of that spot. That's the style and system that Detroit uses when they kill penalties.
It was February of 1994, during the Winter Olympics, that these two teams last met here. It was a 7-2 win for New Jersey, but a lot of personnel has changed, especially for Detroit since then. Do you sense a certain feeling out sort of stage having passed in this game, or is it still underway, Joe?
I think it's starting to develop a little bit right now. And you can see how defense is winning thus far, including the penalty killing.
Unable to get a shot away was Keith Primo. This is on New Jersey's power play time, and now they're able to bring it out. Claude Lemieux is working it ahead. Has John McClain there. Puck tipped back to him, then chipped for Lemieux.
Hussie!
Close quarters. Rouse knocked it along, but it's helped back to the point. Chambers to McClain and across to Albeline. Shoots one. Save made by Vernon. Lifted along by Primo, but kept by Albeline. Albeline able to step by, works it in deep. On back to Albeline again. Penalty time up and a shot. Save made by Vernon in front. And the Red Wings creep back out with it. Chris Draper laying it along, and Albeline sends it back. Both teams have been penalized once. Both have killed it off.
New Jersey's power play looked pretty good, but all their offense was from the defensemen. Mike Vernon in goal. He's got a good look at this shot, but it closes up in a hurry, doesn't it? Puck finds its way through traffic, and he makes another save. The Devils had those three shots, all three from defensemen.
Danico tried to get it ahead. In deep and hustling back is Carpenter. Down he went. Mark Howe up with it. Jammed it on ahead for a play to be made back up ice by Konstantinov. Then flung back in by Iserman. Swept by Brodeur. Driver lost it to McCarty. Tries to get it to the front, but it's poked away by Martin Brodeur. Now Mark Howe pinched in and took the hit. McCarty's pass missed for Iserman, and they have to chase. Konstantinov pursued by Richer. Richer back after him again. Chorsky there to help out too, and Tom Chorsky giving a hit from behind. A little extra shove too coming from Ray Sheppard. And laid on to Sheppard. Shots are 6-2 in favor of New Jersey. They had three on the power play. Out of the 2 minutes, they had a minute five of attack time. No score. Boy, we're glad you're with us tonight on Fox. We'll hear from James Brown and Dave Maloney between periods. What a thrilling setup for a final series. Detroit hasn't won in 40 years, and the city has just gone nuts. Centering pass, but it was blocked off by Brodeur. And all of this is called back because of an offside. Detroit's road has been much more decisive. Unlike New Jersey, they won the season series from all of their opponents and finished higher in the standings than all of their opponents. Pretty clean, isn't it? Only one loss to Dallas and one to Chicago.
That Chicago series, though, those games were close. Score, at least, because of the fine goaltending of Eddie Belfour of the Hawks. Lots of overtime. But certainly these two teams, by far the best two in each conference, and deserve to be right here in the Stanley Cup Finals.
John, I mentioned that the Devils had two fewer days rest to get ready for this. Do you think either team was disadvantaged physically coming in?
I really don't. I think both teams are fairly healthy. All key players are available for the series. It's just, there's a trap turnover now. We'll see if any offense could be generated. No, Detroit comes back nicely.
Laid on now by Coffey. Across for Kozlov. Slava Kozlov holds, got it to Coffey. Shovel one. Stopped by Brodeur, and he will wait.
And Brown went right to the net. Number 17 for Detroit deflected it, and Brodeur makes a tricky little save.
One week from tonight, 19,040 will be watching in person at the Meadowlands Arena in East Rutherford, New Jersey for game four of this best four out of seven series. We hope you'll be watching on Fox. This Stanley Cup Final Series is going to be going to 140 countries around the world. We know of French and English versions, as well as a Russian version coming out of here, and even more are being sent to various countries in different languages, seeing New Jersey play the Detroit Red Wings here in the Stanley Cup Final. Everything just adds to that much more excitement. It's rolled along now by Chambers, ricocheted back in deep, and it's Mike Vernon to set up for Paul Coffey. Around to Ciccarelli and back out. Detroit has been the best offensive team in the NHL the last two full seasons, and in this shortened season of 48 games, finished third, only to Pittsburgh and Quebec. Here is Primo hustling ahead. Shot went wide. And that's the reason they have that kind of impressive offensive numbers. Just a rush like that by Big Keith Primo. Stolen, hit by Primo, but it came over to Peluso. Back up now for Randy McKay. Moves out with Chambers, a defenseman, and gives it to him for the pitch in.
It was one of the few times Detroit's been able to show their speed as they flew through the neutral zone. Primo led the attack and had the scoring chance.
Peluso with a big hit on Fetisov after he released it. Now Danico chips it along, sent further by Mike Peluso. Aubery sends it back in. Detroit with four shots on goal. Konstantinov a shot, and that becomes number five, and a save for Brodeur. Yzerman back to Fetisov for a shot that's deflected back out. Cranked along by Konstantinov, and was he ever hit by Zelopukin? Yeah, the board's being tested, and they're starting to warm to the task here. It's Bill Guerin bringing it on, wanting to get by Mark Howe. Guerin a shot, sticked aside by Vernon. Zelopukin couldn't come up with it. McCarty banged into by Breland. Sergei Breland holding, giving it out for Zelopukin, but it's taken by Bill Guerin. Guerin had it checked away by Steve Yzerman. And Detroit's captain just flies it back.
Strong shift by the Devils because they're hitting, picking up. And they're hoping that the hitting will pick up and make an imprint as the series moves along by trying to wear down some of the smaller Detroit players. Well, here's 420 pounds. Oh, baby, did they collide. Primo and Holík. The Devils have had orders from their coaching staff to finish checks on people like Fedorov, Kozlov, Coffey, Ciccarelli. Bang these players. Bang these players. Try to wear them down. It's all part of the strategy of playoff hockey when you get into a best of seven series.
Not to wear them down physically is one thing, but also test their will a little bit.
Well, there's a lot of will with this Detroit team, but that's what I think makes this series even more interesting to look at. The longer it goes, the tougher it's going to get for these two teams to accomplish anything.
John McClain couldn't get a shot away. Still battling, though. Poked it loose, but Mark Howe took over. Howe in place of Mike Ramsey. The last game of the Chicago series and the first game of this series. If you play one game in the finals and your team wins, you're guaranteed to get your name on the Stanley Cup. Mark's dad has it there a lot of times. And with every Detroit championship, there has been a Howe on the cup. Niedermeyer kicked it around behind, and the puck squirted in front, but it's thrown back up by Draper. Turning with it now is Niedermeyer again. Rushing right back on Coffey. Drops a pass over to Carpenter. Drive, and a save made by Vernon. Rebound, cleared back out. This is an offside play. Kozlov catches up to it. Oh, they let it go. Looked like the point was on and that it would be whistled down, but not the case. Now moving ahead with it is Scott Stevens. Lays it ahead for Richer, but that fails. 80 seconds to go in the period. Kozlov with a pass. Corral go by Chambers. Kozlov tried to take it back. It's worked back for Lidstrom. And away from Richer, and it has to be controlled by Fedorov. Nine shots for New Jersey. Five for Detroit. In the Philadelphia series, in the 18 full periods, the Devils held the Flyers to six shots or less 11 times. That's over half the period's only six shots on goal. That's kind of their measuring stick. Rouse. Save made by Brodeur. And that becomes number six for Detroit. Well, Mark's dad, you're going to see between periods. Legendary Gordie Howe will be along with JB and Dave, and we'll have first period highlights, and this will be great fun.
And Detroit, they've even used Gordie Howe. In the previous series, Sergei Fedorov was having a tough time with a shoulder injury and not playing up to his standards. Gordie Howe had a little talk with him. That at least was what Scotty Bowman, the fine head coach of the Red Wings, was telling me. You know, when you have a little chat and a little session with the almost immortal Gordie Howe, you tend to listen to people like that.
Gordie Howe is on the left and Ted Lindsay on the right. This is a 1950 photograph of them doing the dishes at their apartment in Detroit. Neither of them were making $10,000 at that time. And you see Ted Lindsay, number seven, his number retired, along with Howe and Sid Abel, the center, on that line. The last champion here was in 1955. Gordie Howe was on that squad. Plenty of room here at Joe Louis Arena for more banners.
Broughton, the centerman for New Jersey, was just butted by Iserman. Iserman was asked to move out of the faceoff circle, and Primo takes the draw. Now Primo and Iserman put on the same line here by Scotty Bowman as he juggles his lines a little bit.
Devils control the faceoff, and moving on with it is Neil Broughton. Rammed and sent flying by Primo. And a return hit on Iserman came from Chorsky. Rolled along by Bruce Driver, coming across as Fetisov. Tucked on back, Primo was doing a little hunting on Broughton again. You could see he had him in his sights. Fetisov turning it over for Rouse, working it back up now to Dino Ciccarelli, then across to Big Keith Primo. Primo sized up by Sean Chambers. Primo wheeling behind, a pass in front, and Ciccarelli did not get the type of shot away he wanted.
He may have hit the handle of Brodeur's stick.
To the back now, Fetisov flips one, and that went off a stick. 2 seconds and one. And the period comes to a close after Detroit's best chance of the period.
Set up with some great hitting by Keith Primo on Broughton, and Detroit got a little bit of life going. I think this hits the right handle, the handle above the right glove of Brodeur on the goal stick itself. Watch him go down with it. There's a shot. Yes, right off the handle and just wide. Detroit puts the pressure on late. Both goaltenders had a strong period. And the players now festering a little bit. Ciccarelli and Lemieux, the two number 22s. This could be the start of something.
Well, finally, a little familiarity after the 20 minutes. JB and Dave Maloney and Mr. Hockey, Gordie Howe, when we come back to Joe Louis Arena, where there's no score after one.
The NHL on Fox, the Stanley Cup Final, brought to you by Bud Ice, the official beer sponsor of the NHL. By Dodge, the more things change, the more things look like the new Dodge. By Network MCI Business, install it in your office today. And by Warner Brothers. Warner Brothers Batman Forever is now playing at a theater near you.
Back inside of Joe Louis Arena after a period of play. There is no score, and folks, all of North America certainly knows that jersey, number 9, that belongs to Mr. Hockey, Gordie Howe. And Gordie Howe, it is a pleasure to have you here.
Oh, thank you. It's a pleasure to be this close to the real business out there. And, I guess I get as close as I can with Mark out there. I get that shut up and watch kind of a feeling. It's a little nerve-wracking.
And as Mike Kimmerick and John Davidson said, your son out there playing, do you really get antsy watching him?
Yes, I. As a matter of fact, he must be too, because he left home without saying goodbye today. So, you do get uptight a little bit.
You know, Gordie, you played with the last Stanley Cup winner here in Detroit. Can you compare the nature of the city, how this team has affected the city, as opposed to when you played in 55?
Well, I've never seen so many Red Wing shirts in the jerseys up in the stands, number one. But this is a much bigger crowd. I think they're. I don't think they're any more knowledgeable, but. And the hype. When we start the game, we're introduced, the puck is dropped. Now we have Octopi coming up there. It adds to the excitement.
Now, I know the first cup was probably pretty exciting, but along your illustrious career, is there one that you'd like to have another game back, that you'd like to have back to get another cup under your belt?
Well, I thought my days are over. If there's ever one, I wish it would be right now, because Mark's 40 years of age, and he's getting near the twilight of his career, and I'd like to see the kid have the honor. There's a lot of great hockey players down through the NHL centuries have, you know, been like Bill Gatsby, 21 years as a professional, never was on one. So it's not that easy, and I'd like to see him get his name on the cup.
Most would certainly vote for you as the all-time great 26 years in NHL veteran, and of course scored the cup-winning goal for Detroit, the last cup they won back in 1955. Let's take a look at the highlights from the first period. And Mr. Howe mentioned about the octopus. Well, there it is.
Well, this is the first two-on-one. Bobby Holik's going to get an opportunity here. And Gordie, this one looks like it goes off Vernon's left hand. He's looking around for it. He doesn't know where that thing is, but he's thinking, God, boom, there's old-time hockey. And you know what? You take that one and sit down. We're going to take a highlight here. Dino Ciccarelli, you know, goal scorers seem to find an area of the ice to get ice open, don't they, Gordie?
That and the fact that I've seen a lot of good goal scorers, and when they run into trouble, you look at them and say, are you seeing holes or are you seeing goaltenders?
You speak of holes, here's Paul Coffey. We talked to him about him on the opening, filling that lane, becoming late.
Right.
Man, Paul Coffey, important guy.
Well, Coffey's probably one of the quickest skaters in the league, and even the guys like Fedorov and that, he can stay right with them. He's a lot quicker than a lot of people give him credit for. He's a great hockey player.
One last question about the first period of play. Again, no score. New Jersey can make you look bad with that stifling defense all over. What's going to be important for Detroit to keep in mind in terms of patience?
You know, it's funny. That's the rules we were so used to play under many years ago. We used to have to flood that zone with five guys. So it's not new to me. And it can be broken with a good pass and a lot of speed. And you can see the respect that Jersey has for him. So they're... I think they're collapsing back on the end. Sometime it might hurt you eventually if you keep doing it, but they got that style, and they're a disciplined club, a good club. And you're seeing two clubs that respect one another a great deal. I think the pace will quicken later.
Well, thank you very much. I hope Mark gets his cup and all that good stuff. Let's have some fun here in the finals.
I tell you what, I've never seen him so excited, but that's because he's got another guy from the fraternity here. Thank you very much, Mr. Howe.
I appreciate it. Thank you very much.
All right, Mr. Hockey himself, Gordie Howe, our guest. We've got more action coming your way as Fox NHL Stanley Cup coverage continues.
Thank you, Gordie.
Two teams of contrasting strategies, both of them wanting to dictate the terms here in this scoreless first period. My question to you, John Davidson, is did either of them succeed in dictating terms?
No, I don't think so at all, Mike. And that's exactly why it was so tough to pick a favorite going into this series. Detroit's forwards only had four shots on goal the whole period. I think they'd like to get more from their forwards for sure. Now, this was maybe the best scoring chance. Ciccarelli fights off the check of Neil Broughton, and you see the puck hitting the stick of Brodeur, who loves to put that stick on the ice just like he did there. Not much time, not much space for anybody out there. You have to battle through checks, and that's what Ciccarelli did right at the end of the period. Maybe Detroit's best scoring chance.
Well, within 15 seconds of that, after Claude Lemieux had had his little tip with Ciccarelli, Claude Lemieux paused to talk with Joe Micheletti downstairs.
Claude, first time you have faced the Detroit Red Wings all season long. Did they surprise you at all in the first period?
Not really. I think they basically played the way that we expected them to play, and it was a pretty good period, I think, all around.
Now, they're noted to be a very highly talented offensive team. Do you have to change your style at all as a team to compete against them in the finals?
Well, we got to pay attention to their defensemen. We saw in the first period they joined the play very well, and they like to, create some opportunity for their forward. They'll join the attack anytime they have a chance. So, for us wingers, we got a great job to do, and we got to pay very close attention to guys like Coffey and Lidstrom and Konstantinov.
Thank you, Claude.
So the blind date is history. They know each other pretty well now. Both teams with 15 minutes of rest, and then the second period after this.
The NHL on Fox, the Stanley Cup Finals, brought to you by Dodge. The more things change, the more things look like the new Dodge. By the Discover Card, it pays to discover the card that pays you back. By Canon, a world leader in office equipment. And by Domino's Pizza. When it's gotta be deep, it's gotta be Domino's ultimate deep dish pizza.
No score. Second period about to get underway. No carryover penalties or power plays. The Bud Ice statistical summary, 9-7. New Jersey outshot Detroit. The rest was all even. Scoring chances, 4. Faceoffs, 11. Penalty minutes, 2. And power plays, 0-1. That's only the second time that Detroit has been outshot in a period in these playoffs. The other time was game 4 against Chicago. They lost that game 5-2. They have only been outshot once in any game, and it was in that game.
Mike, one of the matchups here as we start the second period is Ciccarelli against Claude Lemieux. Both wear number 22. Lemieux played right wing in the last series for the Devils. He can move to left wing here, and I think specifically to try and get on Dino Ciccarelli, who has 8 goals, and nobody on Detroit has scored more in the playoffs.
Konstantinov with a pass that's taken by Claude Lemieux and rolled back to Howe. Then Konstantinov and ahead to Ciccarelli. Kicked away by Tommy Albelin on defense for New Jersey. Now here's Primo stepping in. Keith Primo had to turn away. Cut off by Bobby Holík. Able to give it ahead. Randy McKay pulls up. McKay out, man, just threw it to the front. Paul Coffey there, but McKay forechecking well. And then over to Holík. Quick stiff shot handled by Vernon. Big hit by Peluso on Coffey. Off of Ciccarelli. Right back where Vernon has to help out, and it came to Stevens. Scott Stevens laying it back off. Centering pass by McKay fails, taken by Ciccarelli, and flipped into the glove of Sean Burr. Leaves it for Primo. Bobby Holik takes that pass, and Scott Stevens. Tipped along by McKay. Taken by Airy for Coffey. Couple of players go down. Meanwhile, Paul Coffey flies it ahead, giving up the wing for Bob Airy's shot that's deflected right into the glove of Martin Brodeur. And play once again is stopped.
Starting to see just a little bit of pushing and shoving. Here we go. After the whistle, Bob Airy is involved with Broughton this time. Coffey jumped in on the play again, as Dave Maloney mentioned during the intermission, but he did not get the puck back from Bob Airy this time, as Detroit will try to formulate a system to get some offense. This guy, Broughton, has played very well for the Devils since he was acquired from the Dallas Stars. Remember back in 1980, he was one of Herb Brooks' fine centermen that won the gold medal in the Olympics. The other two, Mark Pavlich, who played for the Rangers and retired, and Mark Johnson. The three of them did a great job. I talked to Herb Brooks the other day. He would love to see an NHL team back in the city of Minneapolis where Herbie lives. I think he'd like to be part of it, to be honest with you.
Well, Mark Johnson is part of a minor league team in the Colonial League called the Madison Monsters. He is going to be the coach of that team next year. And Mark Pavlich, I think we can safely say, in the middle of June, is fishing. Here's Lidstrom moving in. Lidstrom with a backhander, and he flew it wide. Don McLean steps to it for New Jersey. Early stages, second period. No score in our game. It is Broughton ahead. Broughton shoved down. Paul Coffey starts it back in a two-on-two with Yzerman. Paul Coffey moving it on. Talented defenseman for Detroit. Shoots one. Kicked back out by Brodeur. And Detroit will recoil at center ice.
So far in this game, Broughton's been knocked down at least three times. You can see how the Red Wings are trying to take the body on Broughton as much as possible. And for New Jersey, they've shown at least four body checks already into Paul Coffey.
Doug Brown's shot went off Brodeur and was wide. Kozlov checked off by Bruce Driver. Follow-up came from Carpenter. Carpenter will have to take it further. Bobby Carpenter, one-time 50-plus goal scorer for the Washington Capitals, put it in on goal. Easy stop for Vernon. Handed to Fetisov and then sent back out. Kozlov, rammed by Niedermeyer and taken right out. Well, that's following through on the check, John. Rolled back ahead, and Kozlov up with it again. Flips but misses for Brown.
Kozlov, one of those players the coaching staff for New Jersey said, finish your checks on, and you just saw it a moment ago.
The jostling continues. Brown's pass came to Stephane Richer, but up the boards. Rouse with a shot off the stick in front of Doug Brown, and also off the stick of Brodeur. Lemieux really hit. Boy, he let go a pass, and just that moment he was creamed from the side. Good solid hit that came from Bob Rouse. Brown turned it back in. Ooh, a little headhunting there by Kozlov. Bobby Albelin starting to pick up in the meanness category now. Kozlov rustled off, and it is Mark Howe putting it around behind. Could not get to the front. Primo could not. Niedermeyer turns it ahead.
Kozlov just took a shot from Breland, who took a shot from Kozlov earlier on the shift.
Guerin's shot deflected away. Guerin back to the point, but at neutral ice. They reconvene. 16:20 to go in the second period of our game. No! Devils making another change. Doc Lemaire is known for getting the guys out that he wants, but he's up against the best guy at preventing it, Scotty Bowman. That's another one of the matchups that is of such great interest in this playoff series.
Should be a classic. I think right now the Devils happen to be dictating the speed and tempo. Detroit wants to jack it up much, much quicker. They have not been able to do it so far.
Good shoulder by Primo on Ken Danico. Meanwhile, it is Peluso trying to shake it through in camp. Twisting with it is Ray Shepard. Handing it on for Rouse. Then back up the wing it comes. Pass chipped away by Randy McKay. Right back to the corner, but Bobby Holik up with it. Holik just flips it back. Nicholas Lidstrom cranks it back in. Brodeur could only slow that one. Danico to the corner trying to play it. Knocked around for Steve Yzerman. McCarty after it. Turns there. McCarty poked it back over for Yzerman and then was sent flat by Stevens. All Coffey rolled it around behind. McCarty couldn't reach that one. Big Mike Peluso could. 6 feet four, he's sent flying by Steve Yzerman, 5'11". Dumped along now for Holik. pumped it along further. Nearly 5 minutes played in this second period.
That's the anticipation of what the first goal may mean in this game.
Man.
25 minutes in, and you can just feel it getting more and more tense in this building as the defense is winning.
Two shots on goal by New Jersey in this period, and one by Detroit. That's it, and over 5 minutes played. Fedorov couldn't get a shot away. Right back comes John McClain again. McClain moving in with Chorsky. Couldn't get away from Coffey. Now has to retrieve it. Threw one off of Vernon. Bruce Driver will chase it back. Well, the Devils' system has worked thus far. Detroit has not scored. They really haven't had that many loud fouls, as they'd say in baseball. Burr with a shot. Ricocheted off a pair. Following up now is Routh. Rotten and then Ciccarelli tied. Gets into it. Let's go, Red Wings. Centering pass and a shot right on goal by Burr is stopped by Brodeur.
Great pass out of the corner. Great shot by Burr, and Brodeur, his best of the game. The hitting picking up. Kozlov watches back in the top of the boards. Oh, man, that had to hurt. Primo, when he hits, he explodes. Look at this on Danico. And then the great scoring chance for Sean Burr was robbed by Brodeur.
Claude Lemieux bringing it ahead for New Jersey. Taken right away by Ciccarelli. Back for Rouse. But it's Alvelin. Bobby Carpenter got help from Lemieux. And then on for Stephane Richer. Richer, the most dangerous of the one-on-one players, number 44. Lemieux got it over to him. Richer trying to get by him. Boy, you can't stick handle past that. That was a hit by Primo. Around behind now. Turning with it and feeding with a leak. Alvelina shot that ricocheted on back.
You know, these two teams getting a lot of rest prior to the beginning of the finals. The big guys that love to hit, like Primo, are well rested. And you can see he's fresh. He's thrown four or five huge body checks on behalf of his Detroit hockey club.
It is Coffey, pursued by Holik. Bumped into Kozlov. All Coffey threw it back down. Scott Stevens there, but Brodeur sent it off the glass and off Lidstrom. Follow up comes from Neil Broughton. Broughton controlling, unable to get through, and then fights his way by. Taken right back over by Fedorov. Sergei Fedorov hands it across to Kozlov moving in. Kozlov to Brown, and Doug Brown centered one that went off Brodeur and wide. Fedorov couldn't come up with it. A 3-on-2 for New Jersey. John McClain up the wing. Gives over to Broughton. Off his stick. It'll be offside. Play is stopped here at Joe Louis Arena in the second period. No score.
Corliss here in the second period. And this is starting to fester. The two number 22s. They went at it a bit in the first period. And here in the second period, it's getting tougher. Both of them like to draw penalties. Both like to be involved in the offense, and both are terrific playoff players.
Konstantinov from the faceoff to Mark Howe. Hands on to Steve Yzerman. Yzerman moving in, but offside is called. Claude Lemieux does more badgering verbally, but he still winds up drawing penalties, as he did from Konstantinov in the first, when he sort of invited him to grab onto his stick and hold on. Ciccarelli is especially good at tumbling to the ice at the right time.
Before the Boston series, Claude Lemieux knew that he had to go up against a great goal scorer and one of the leaders in Boston, Cam Neely. Lemieux said he couldn't sleep before the series. It really bothered him knowing what his role would be, but he got business taken care of. Then you think about Dino Ciccarelli, the goal scorer that he can be around the goal net. Here's a guy that has his playoff goals, 66 of them, 12 of them overtime playoff game winners, and he leads his club in that regard.
Lemieux only had 6 in the regular season, but now leads everybody in the playoffs with 11. Puck trickled through and Coffey will go back.
Lemieux said it's like a golfer on the pro tour, like a Freddie Couples or Ray Floyd or Greg Norman, who get into that zone and they know they're going to play well. He said right now he's like a pro golfer. He's in the zone and he knows he's going to play well.
It is Bruce Driver up with this one, but then he lost it. In come the Red Wings. It's Fedorov with a shot. He hit the post with the shot. Back now for Lidstrom, and a shot went off of Tom Chorsky's stick. You think we've seen enough iron already in this playoff final? under the metal roof that helps the noise at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Two teams battling for the Stanley Cup. The New Jersey Devils and Detroit Red Wings, along with John Davidson, Joe Micheletti, of course, James Brown and Dave Maloney. I'm Mike Emmerich. There's no score in the game. 20 shots have been fired. The goalies have gotten them all. The shots are 11-9 in favor of New Jersey, two apiece. And 8.5 minutes have been played in the second period right now. Stephane Richer turning with it. Kicked it along now for Chambers. Chambers tucked the pass on up for Claude Lemieux. Could not get by. Much is made of New Jersey's zone trap in the center ice area. But a lot of times it's easy to forget that the leading offensive team, Detroit, can play some great center ice defense too.
They like to keep their left winger back and allow the centerman and right winger to do the forechecking. The Detroit team felt that they played well in the first period, but they wanted their team to hit the net a little more. Their scoring chances, I remember Primo having one, he missed the net. They want more direct attack on Martin Brodeur.
De Larry Robinson, assistant coach, and a guy who is rumored to be going almost anywhere, that there's a head coaching job for next year. Devils are 8-1 away from home, and the Red Wings are perfect at home. If this goes 5 and the Red Wings win their 3, they will tie an NHL record. 11 straight set by the 88 Edmonton Oilers. 11 out of 11 at home. That's down the road in this best of 7. Dino Ciccarelli poised, waiting for this faceoff that will involve Freeland and Keith Primo.
They're calling Dino Elvis with those sideburns.
Here's Alvaline coming up with it. A backhander. Oh, and it nearly stinked through, and Vernon blocked it. Thrown to the front of the net again. That one knocked down by the defense, played away by Fetisov. Fetisov goes down, and so does Bill Guerin. They still scrap for it, and we get a stoppage of play.
One pattern we're seeing is the team that's the offensive team is winning the faceoffs in the other team's zone, getting offense because of it. And we just saw it a second ago. The defensive team, which generally should win 60-65% of their faceoffs, it's just not happening. And in a game where it's scoreless and offense is hard to find, look at New Jersey. Loose puck, the Devils get in there, and you see it's now controlled by the Devils hockey club. The puck is to the net, Vernon with the save. And it's not a clean win, but it's a hard battle to find the puck. There's Billy Guerin, a big winger, driving in front, trying to find a rebound, and Vernon's been solid with the shots through traffic.
Left shoulder, a problem for Fedorov, who is out there now but not taking the faceoff. In the first period, he won 1 out of 6. 1-1 and lost 5 faceoffs. This is Doug Brown to take the draw, number 17 opposite Bobby Holík. And kickback for Fetisov. 10:40 to go in the second period. We have no score.
Another quick change by the Devils. They'd love to get their best checking line on the ice. And that's centered by Bobby Carpenter against Fedorov. Against Fedorov as much as possible.
Paul Coffey always winds up with a ton of ice time during the course of a game.
He played over 11 minutes in the first period. He's averaged 4.3 shots on goal per game throughout the playoffs. He had one shot in the first period, but you see Scotty Bowman keeps him on the bench when New Jersey puts their best defensive line out there, and they're now on the ice. That's centered by Carpenter.
Alvaline with a shot. Easy play for Vernon, and then he had to take a tough rebound attempt from Bobby Carpenter.
Mike, another example of the offensive team winning the draw. Carpenter's line beat the Red Wing line for the faceoff, got the shot, and Vernon allowed the puck to slip away from his catching glove and had to make a good second save. Look at Carpenter win the draw. Alvaline goes to the left side. Now watch in front the battle as there he comes, Claude Lemieux and Bobby Carpenter. Carpenter fought away two different Red Wings to get the rebound. Perhaps those players thought there wasn't going to be a rebound. A little shot by Draper, who lost the draw to Bobby Carpenter.
Two minor penalties in the game, both in the first period. One a hold and one a stick hold.
Draper, for that little shot, gets a penalty. So the Devils get their second power play. Their first power play, their offense was generated by an defenseman with a puck, as you see here.
Alvaline over to Richer. Fires and a score! Oh, I thought Vernon had that one, and it found its way through, and it is a 1-0 lead right off the faceoff for New Jersey.
Detroit losing faceoffs, including the one that led to the first goal of the game. Draper taking a penalty after a whistle, which was unnecessary. That hurts his hockey club. Watch the faceoff won by Broughton. Now on the left side, you've got Richer. There he is. He's with the puck. He looks, and he just maybe has the best shot on this New Jersey Hockey Club. He finds a way to put it through Mike Vernon. There's Broughton after winning the drop. Look at his focus. Look at Vernon. He sees now that he's going to get the shot. Here comes from Richer, and Richer powers the puck underneath him. 1-0 on a power play, New Jersey. A look at it. I think Vernon had a good sight line here to find the shot. Yes, you'll see it here. But it's squeezed underneath his leg.
Richer from Albaline and Broughton on the power play for New Jersey. This is the 17th Devil game, and they have taken a 1-0 lead in 14 of them. And this team is so strong with the lead. Fedorov could not get by Stevens. A one-goal lead is really about 1 3/4 with these guys. And a two-goal lead is like 3, especially when they're on the road. Around behind Fedorov, couldn't snake it to the front. Instead, it's Kozlov, a pass knocked away, poked along by Stevens. Danico flips, and McLean dumps it along. Hand passed ahead by Coffey in a stoppage of play. Richer, the only goal, just halfway into this contest. Just back to action here. Stephane Richer, the only goal scorer in the game. The Devils have succeeded in slowing this game down in the second period. And now that they have the goal, you may see even more of that.
And they'll wait, and then they'll try to counter. They'll be patient because of their experience.
Carpenter shot. Oh, and the light is on. Did it come right back out? Apparently it did. The light is on, and we are not certain whether this one is going to count or not.
Now the question is, did it go in low and back out? The National Hockey League uses video replay. They'll be able to tell from the overhead view. Watch the turnover. Richer's there. Sloppy pass from in behind. Immediate offense. And the shot, as you see, underneath everybody and maybe underneath the goaltender, Mike Vernon. Sloppy pass from behind the net by Bob Airey. He then screens goaltender Mike Vernon. I think the puck may have gone inside the goalpost, over the goal line, along the padding, and back out. If not, it hit the goalpost, one or the other. The net cam may show it here. Good quick shot? No, you can't tell. The way it ricocheted back out on that replay, it may have been just the goalpost, and Mike Vernon hangs on. Does it go inside the goalpost and back out, or off the goalpost? Mike, that looks like the goalpost. Detroit with a turnover. The patient play of New Jersey, they get the scoring chance, and Mike Vernon has a goalpost to help him out.
77 games have been played, and video replay this playoff year has been used 17 times. You saw some of the reasons for it. 7 different criteria can be determined, and in all but one of them, it determines whether a goal has been scored or not. 6th straight game that Detroit has allowed the first goal. The entire Chicago series that was done. That is Dave Newell, longtime veteran official, on the telephone, communicating down to the referee.
Bobby Carpenter with the shot. The way the puck came back out so quick, you'd often make you believe that it had to hit the goalpost. The way the fans are now responding here, it's been waved off. It definitely hits the goalpost there. And back underneath Mike Vernon. I think Bob Airey may be the happiest guy in the world. He gave the puck away from behind the net. Not a defenseman, but a forward with a puck back there. Richer with a turnover. And Jacques Lemaire's team, their game right now going their way.
So we've had a crossbar, a right post, and a right post. And only one goal, Stephane Richer. Teams are at full strength.
Keith Primo back on the ice. He had retired to the Detroit locker room for a shift or two. I don't know what the problem was, but it looks like he's back and he's ready for action the way he's flying out there.
It is Bobby Holík. Holík stepping ahead with a pass that goes right in on Vernon. Dino Ciccarelli. Pass ahead is nudged further by Howe, but corralled by Stevens and then lost. Trying to bully his way to the front, but going down with Sean Burr. Stevens hurries it ahead off Bobby Holík. Stevens can carry on. Scott Stevens, Devils captain. Defended from behind by Primo, and it's laid right back down. Can Danico after it, but Burr got there first. Sean Burr, fed it across, turning with it. It's Batisov out in front. Oh, and they couldn't get it home. Batisov remarkably had Ciccarelli to Slava Fetisov again. A penalty coming up against New Jersey on this touch. And then Burr rams into Ken Danico. A high sticking call to Danico. A power play to the Red Wings, who trail the Devils 1-0.
Great scoring chance by Detroit. Look at Ciccarelli on the right side, but Holík smartly back-checking, breaks up the pass from Fetisov. All the Detroit offense so far, it's either been Ciccarelli with the shot, or Ciccarelli with the screen, or Ciccarelli drawing the penalties. He's been terrific, yet they haven't been able to score.
He's out on the power play right now, but the Devils have it. Broughton feeds on out of John McClain, one-on-one with Lidstrom. And McClain just plops one that is spiked down by Vernon. Bobby Holík, the high-sticking miner at 11:37 of the second period. Fedorov trying to work his way in, can't. Driver turns it back. Lidstrom and Coffey will be the point men just inside the blue line once they get it set up. A lot of talent out there now. Iserman as well as Fedorov and Ciccarelli. But the puck comes over to Broughton. Very deliberately walking it ahead. Neil Broughton defended there by Lidstrom, and the puck poked over from McClain, and a save made by Vernon as it came right over to John McClain for a slapper. Lidstrom cranks it back in. Around it swirls near Scott Niedermeyer, the Devils' defense. Ciccarelli there to bump with him. It came along from McClain, and he put it back out.
Nothing working for Detroit. They've tried twice to carry the puck into the New Jersey zone on the power play. Didn't work. They tried to dump in. It didn't work. Here's another dump in, and let's see if the white jerseys can get the puck back from the dark jerseys.
So far, not. Fedorov flipped it, and Shepard got it back to the front. Coffey along now to Ciccarelli. Then over for Ray Shepard. Walks in front, tries to get a shot away and can't do it. It's taken by Ciccarelli again. Dino Ciccarelli back to the point to Coffey. Other point, Lidstrom drive, and it went wide. Rebound! Score! Ciccarelli! Tie game!
Oh, if you like octopus, there's got to be 30 of them on the ice right now. Oh, what a play. It took a minute and 20 seconds for Detroit to get into the offensive zone on the power play and control the puck. Oh. A minute 20 seconds. That gave them 40 seconds of power play time to go to work and watch them move the puck. Ciccarelli's got it. There's a man right in front, that's Shepard. Here's a shot that goes wide, and Brodeur had to chase it, but he couldn't recover. Here comes Ciccarelli all by himself. The key is in front. Two men went to one. Ciccarelli's a right-handed shot, so he could snap the puck quickly. We're tied up at one. That's one power play goal apiece in this game. Shot goes wide. Brodeur had to chase it. Can he recover? Not quite. Ciccarelli was right there. Detroit's offense is all Ciccarelli so far in this game.
Ciccarelli has tied the game. Joe Micheletti is downstairs.
And Doc, just prior to that goal, the shorthanded chance by John McClain, he misses it. He came back to the bench, told his teammates on the bench, if I would have put the puck on the ice, it would have gone in, and Detroit turns around to tie the game. Back to you, Doc.
Okay, thanks, Joe.
Credit Mike Vernon with a big save off of John McClain. Vernon moved out, played the angle perfectly, hoping McClain would hit him with a puck. That's exactly what he did. Now, what McClain's talking about is if a goaltender's moving out at you and you shoot the puck on the ice, you can't move your feet. If you're moving out, you can't move your feet to the sides. I think if McClain had it over again, as he just mentioned, he'd love to shoot it low on the ice.
Ciccarelli from Lidstrom and Coffey at 13:08. Ciccarelli now with 6 power play goals in the playoffs, and he leads the league in that department.
Mike Vernon, when he played goal for the Calgary Flames, had the famous Hall of Famer Glenn Hall help him out with goaltending as a coach. Here's Vernon. Read the play. Now he's moving out. He's moving out. You see him take the angle, bang. If the puck's on the ice, he doesn't move the feet under control. If you ever get a chance to skate, folks, you move out, skating forward, just try to move your feet to your side. You can't do it. And if the puck's on the ice, that's a hard save to make unless you're set for the shot.
So one of the living legends, Glenn Hall, taught him. Is there that much that is carried through that are just a part of the basics of goaltending from Glenn Hall's time back in the 50s to now?
Both were similar in size, Mike Vernon and Glenn Hall, but Glenn Hall was more of an acrobatic goaltender. Mike Vernon more of a stand-up, play the angle type goaltender. But there's also the mental aspect of it, how to be tough mentally, how to deal with when you don't get shots, how to deal with big playoff games. And Mike Vernon is as tough mentally as it gets, and he credits Glenn Hall for a lot of it.
Sergei Fedorov in this 1-1 tie, pulls away from one, passes too far. Rotten trying to come up with it, but it's Fedorov again. Fedorov trying to get by, centered one, and a sliding play made by Chambers, and the puck sent into the seats.
Detroit score the goal, they start picking it up, the fans getting into it. The turnover this time goes to Detroit, but New Jersey recovers. They try the pass across. Look at the right defenseman, Chambers. He's making the pass. It doesn't work with Broughton, as Broughton was about to be hit again. But Chambers, that same defenseman, will move across here when Stevens was caught standing still, and he intercepts the pass coming across. Great play by Chambers. Here's Fedorov. Look at the change of speed to go around Scott Stevens, who was flat-footed. Now Brodeur is caught on one side. If that pass is completed, it probably would have been 2-1 Detroit. But Chambers, the other defenseman, came over and helped out his partner, Scott Stevens, by making the block of the pass.
From this tie-up, the puck loose, and Yzerman goes down and draws the penalty against New Jersey.
This is something you don't see often. Claude Lemieux taking a penalty. He doesn't do it often in the playoffs. Detroit tied it up on the power play. Here's another one. Power play coming up. Claude Lemieux, who we circled, will move out nicely. He picks his man nicely. He sees the puck going to maybe go to him, so he reaches out with a stick and takes a lazy penalty and hooking down Stevie Yzerman. So another power play for Detroit, and they have their only goal on the power play.
One for the prior two are the Red Wings. Lidstrom with Coffey gives it to him. Coffey, a shot deflected, and that one went up into the seats.
And again, Ciccarelli, this time the offensive team again wins the faceoff, control the puck on the power play. And when that happens, Dino, who has some words there with the goaltender, goes to the front. Watch his head, his eyes. He's watching the puck all the time. Outside the goal crease, the way you're supposed to be. Stick is free. There's the deflection. Maybe off the crossbar after it hit a stick. And then he pays. Dino Ciccarelli is one of the best ever to play the game around the goal net. And because of his hands, he's able to deflect the pucks in a subtle fashion. There the puck went off the crossbar off of that stick. So the faceoff's outside the zone. Mr. Offense in this one for Detroit is Ciccarelli.
Coming back from an alleged slight muscle tear in the right thigh. We say alleged because these things aren't verified most times. Back ahead with it comes Paul Coffey. 100 seconds of power play time. Racing on in, but being denied was Fedorov. Boy, the defense closed quickly. That was Scott Stevens along with Danico. Up front, New Jersey kills with Bobby Carpenter and Tom Jorski. Fedorov and Ciccarelli working along with Steve Yzerman. The usual five are out there on the power play, but this puck to the seats. William Scott Bowman, playing in 1951, was felled by an opponent's stick. That was the end of his playing days, and then he went into coaching. And what a career he has made of that.
He has changed through the decades with the game, on the ice, off the ice. When they beat Chicago, he ran on the ice to celebrate. And some of his players go, we've never seen him do that, including Bob Airey, who played for him in Pittsburgh when they won a cup before. Scotty Bowman, it was mentioned to me by Ted Sater, one of the assistant coaches or coaches in St. Louis with the Blues. He said, Scotty reminds him of Don Shula, able to change with the times, continue with success. And you see Scotty right there trying to get another ring.
Don McLean tried to clear, could not. Puck taken by Yzerman, spins it back around, waiting for it as Coffey punches around to Yzerman again. Long for Fedorov. A little trouble, but he got it on to Yzerman. Tommy Alvelin on him, it's back to Lidstrom. Then Coffey, close quarters, dogged a lot by Brock. In it comes to Fedorov. Centered one, and it came right across to McLean, and he brushed it back out. 5 minutes to go in the second, game tied at one, and 40 seconds left on the Detroit power play. Ray Sheppard brings it on. Ciccarelli has remained out. Brodeur flings it off Ciccarelli's stick. Primo hit from behind, puck back to the point, but away from Coffey, and so they have to regroup. So Martin Brodeur, who does not come out of the net much, took a chance there. Slava Fetisov, the one-time Devil, long-time member of the Soviet Red Army team, put that one back in. Stevens took the hit, rolled it back along. Coffey kept it alive. Then to Sheppard, flips it behind, out in front, Airy rammed the net after he misfired on that one. Did he ever pay the price from Bobby Carpenter?
And maybe bad news for Detroit. Keith Primo's gone back to their locker room.
Here's Fetisov around behind. Fetisov for a drive by Sheppard, and that one blocked down. Coffey has shot. Oh, and a save. Brodeur, and he covers, and play is stopped.
And Brodeur made that save with his goal stick out by the circle. Great goaltending. Look at the festering now of the players as this series picks up. Primo to the locker room. It could be a problem. As the Detroit power play expired, Detroit got their best offense. The shot there was blocked. But watch three forwards assemble around the goal crease of Brodeur, who had lost his goal stick. And one of them is Dino Ciccarelli. The others, Bob Airy, Ray Sheppard, they're all there. And a good save by Brodeur, by Brodeur. Now here's Primo moving in and hit hard. Oh, whiplash maybe, as he's hit by Scott Stevens. And you see a grimace. And he headed across to the bench. And then he went to the locker room. And as of yet, I don't believe his return.
There were penalties on that little scuffle after. Ciccarelli and Danico roughing minors apiece, so it's 4-on-4 hockey for the first time of the series. Neil Broughton turning back with it. Pass was through Richer. Swept on back. Moving toward it, Sheppard, but throwing it back off Chambers. And Driver connects with Broughton. 3:42 to go in the period. A 1-1 tie. They lead it to Richer. Konstantinov on him. They cancel. Richer sweeping it back and hooked it behind. Chris Draper turns. Another of the heroes of the Chicago series. Draper got help from Howe and back up the wing. Little pass is on to Draper again. Picks up Konstantinov. Offside.
Hold up there, guys. Hold up. Hold up.
At the conclusion of our game, John and I will select a Jeep player of the game. There's a good nominee right there. We just saw Dino Ciccarelli. The ever-tough Ken Danico. Claude Lemieux has been one of the stronger Devil players during this entire playoff run.
And both goaltenders have been good in this game with a little help from the goalposts and crossbars. Four-on-four action, the first portion of it, the first 46 seconds, we did not see very much develop. Now Paul Coffey's on the ice. Niedermeyer, the great skater for New Jersey in their defense, we may see something now.
Steve Yzerman. Led over for Coffey. Punched along by Niedermeyer. Chorsky, but Yzerman. Yzerman watched by Niedermeyer. The hit. Loose puck, dug out by Fedorov. But it is Niedermeyer. And around behind, he had taken a hit, but it's Alvelin up with it. The 4-on-4 time is down to 43 seconds. And here's a 2-on-1. Chorsky moving in. Play is stopped again, and the iron continues to play a factor in the game.
And Paul Coffey blocked the shot, and he is injured. He has hurt his leg. He now gets up to try to get off. Here's the play where Yzerman, you see, he gets in behind Chorsky, 2-on-1. This shot hurts Coffey, hurt one of his legs, I believe his right leg. Now watch the puck up in the air. Vernon with a great save. Niedermeyer's there, and the puck is banged away, and Chorsky knocks the net off to Mooring. Coffey took the puck on the leg. He's grimacing now. The right leg's in the air. Look at his face. He's grimacing. And he was banged up. He went right to the bench. And hopefully for Detroit, he'll be okay. He made a good play with the block, with the 2-on-1 that New Jersey had. Coffey down. Ooh, right off the outside of the right ankle. Shot never got through until the end. And look at Vernon sweep his left hand in the air, knocking the puck away. Coffey now has to wait out the process of the pain on the ankle. And hopefully for him, it'll go away.
In terms of getting the speed that they like, that is the guy that does it by handling and does it by passing, Paul Coffey. And you had made the point before he came out on that last shift that things might change because he was there. The speed would be back.
He ends up making a great defensive play, which is one of the parts of his game that has improved the most this season. He's become a good defensive, real good.
Better off. Scott Stevens. Zelapukin along now for Guerin. Both teams get a man back. So it's full strength hockey as we're down to the last 2 minutes of the period. Both teams with a power play goal in this one. Richer and Ciccarelli from New Jersey and Detroit. Both of those goals have come in the second. Richer with the steal. Stephane Richer took some lumber, still controlling. Too much Detroit. Dumped back off again by Rouse. Waiting for it as Chambers. Shoots one that's tipped in front by a Red Wing. Thrown into traffic and up with it Lemieux. Tried to hook one to the front block by the defense. Alive by Driver. Flings one wide. Ciccarelli steps to it. Chambers kept it alive. Flipped along by Richer. Matisoff rolls it. Richer took it. Along now for Claude Lemieux. Centering pass ricocheted back. You can sense some concern going through the seats now in this 1-1 tie.
This is the checking line. The Carpenter line against Fedorov that's keeping the puck pinned in the Detroit zone. That's a great shift by them. They didn't score. They didn't get any offense, but they kept the puck in that zone, and Fedorov's line did not get out, so they couldn't get offense.
Howe sends it around. Lemieux kept it alive. Lemieux flipped one in front that was blocked away by Vernon. From defense to offense, it's Rouse. And back in for Brodeur. Young goaltender from New Jersey rolls it back along. It's tipped further. Neil Broughton can't get there. Instead, Konstantinov. Weak pass. Chorsky comes up with it. Tom Chorsky back to the point. Stevens trickled one across. One-time shot by Niedermeyer goes into the seats and play is stopped.
So Brodeur fired the puck out of the zone. He was a forward until he was 9 years of age. That's where he learned to handle the puck.
This telecast is presented by authority of the National Hockey League and is intended for the private use of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this telecast, including the imposition of a charge for viewing it without the express written consent of the National Hockey League, is prohibited.
Now let's see, with under a minute to go here in the second period, will the pattern continue of the offensive team winning the draws, the faceoff in the other zone? Detroit made a late change to get Steve Yzerman and the winger Bob Airey, a defensive winger, on the ice here to go against Neil Broughton. Let's watch and see what happens.
Up for grabs and thrown out by Airey.
Yeah, that's why Airey was put on the ice. He's smart, he's quick, and as soon as there was a loose puck, he jumped to find it with his skates and got the puck out of the zone. Good play.
Icing had, call.
Right, icing. So now the faceoff goes all the way to the New Jersey zone, and the strategy changes. Will Scotty Bowman put out offense with 26.1 seconds to go? As Coffey now comes off the bench for his first shift since he blocked the shot with his right foot. So that's instant offense right away with Detroit, thinking they may win the draw. And New Jersey stays with their same fivesome, including Broughton, to go against Yzerman once again for the faceoff.
Neil Broughton out of Roseau, Minnesota. Ready to take this faceoff opposite Yzerman.
Neil Broughton almost went to college at the University of North Dakota, but Herbie Brooks and company talked him out of it in favor of University of Minnesota.
From this faceoff, McLean went down, but still swept it back to center ice. It is Lidstrom. It'd be treasonous for a Minnesota guy to shoot. Here's McLean with a shot, gloved down by Paul Coffey in the final eight of the period, kept alive by Niedermeyer. Then Tom Chorsky, Coffey on him. 2 seconds to go. It is McCarty, and it is over for two periods.
Mike Vernon chipped the puck away from the goal net with a stick. Both goaltenders have been good doing that. Pass outs from behind the net, the little goal sticks are right there.
James Brown and Dave Maloney will be coming up after these important messages. Second period completed. Red Wings won. Devils won.
The NHL on Fox, the Stanley Cup Finals, brought to you by Eagle. Test drive the all-new Eagle talent at your local Eagle dealer. Fox's coverage of the Stanley Cup Finals continues next Saturday when the Red Wings face off against the Devils in Game 4 at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific.
And back inside of Joe Louis Arena, along with Dave Maloney, I'm James Brown. And after two periods of play, we are tied at one. And Dave, there's no question about it, with the score tied at one after two periods of play, important for Detroit to have gotten on the scoreboard, because we know New Jersey is an excellent road team, 8-1 on the road.
They're 8-1 on the road, JB, because of the style they play. You know, they're very
very disciplined. But when you speak of playoff to hockey, you talk about special teams and goaltending. Two power play goals, and Mike Vernon made a huge save right before Ciccarelli's power play goal. This has it all. They've been banging. Good goaltending and special teams. Been a good two periods of hockey.
Certainly a lot more action in that second period to play as we take a look at. Keith Primo has a hat trick early on by way of the check, nailing Mike Peluso.
There he is, the big old guy's rumbling here at Joe Louis. And there we go. Okay, you want to go? That goes skate away. That's Sue Grips. And this is the first power play. You know, today at the skate, in the morning skate, the Wings worked on the faceoff. Didn't work here. Puck comes off the right point. Stephane Richer, a real fine shot. Now, gonna get back on the board here, Detroit. Lindstrom's gonna drive it wide. And Dino Ciccarelli, as JD has said during the period, he's been Johnny on the spot, been most of the offensive. By golly, he's a pretty excited cowboy. He should be, played very, very well. Ciccarelli, we're gonna take another look at it. But again, Brodeur had to move off the shot off the right point from Nicholas Lindstrom. But again, open ice is crucial for the Red Wings offense. They capitalized and tied it at one.
Ciccarelli makes a living right there in front of the goal as usual. We talked about that tying goal to make it one all. 10th all-time in playoff goals for Dino Ciccarelli. 67, one fewer than the guy we had here during the first intermission.
Well, I think so. You know, the difference is he's so small. He's a feisty character. You know, you whack him once, you whack him twice, he comes back. He's been doing it a long time. He's a good hockey player.
All right, game one of the Stanley Cup Finals taking place here after two periods of play, all tied at one. And when we come back, we'll have some football news for you. But first, a couple of players in tonight's game recognize that tomorrow is Father's Day. Devils goalie Martin Brodeur and Red Wings defenseman Paul Coffey recently became proud papas.
It's probably the thing that's made me most proud of my whole life. Having your own child, really, that's what it's all about. And the Stanley Cups are probably the pinnacle in sports, but being there to see the birth of your first child is just incredible.
It's about the same thing, you know. I think it's one thing I wanted to have as a kid, and now, you know, we have one, and it's just great. And now Stanley Cup Final, you know, it's a good year for me. But you know, it's all brand new to me, so I'm kind of just going with the flow right now. I don't think any father would sacrifice a Father's Day to be in my position, I'm sure.
There was a time when the shouting was elsewhere. Old Olympia Stadium, great old brick arena, which was the Red Wings' home until 1980. It was leveled. Now it's just a memory. Corner of Grand River and McGraw. A lot of hockey memories there, and seven Detroit championships, and now an armory stands there. Olympia's gone, and the Red Wings are in their first Stanley Cup Final at Joe Louis Arena. 40 minutes have been played in the first of the best of seven. New Jersey and the Red Wings are tied at one each.
The NHL on Fox, the Stanley Cup Finals, brought to you by Warner Brothers. Warner Brothers Under Siege 2 starts Friday, July 14th at a theater near you. By Bud Ice, the official beer sponsor of the NHL. By Nike, who encourages you to participate in the lives of America's youth. And by the United States Army Reserve. Be all you can be. For more information, call 1-800-USA-ARMY.
The Devils normally play low-scoring games and low-shot games. Detroit has had only 12 shots and has scored once. New Jersey, 19 shots and has scored once. Dino Ciccarelli was asked by Joe Micheletti about the defensive system of New Jersey through two periods.
It's pretty tough. There's not a lot of time or space out there. We played a patient game ourselves all season, and I think both teams were kind of feeling each other out first 10 minutes, but there's not a whole lot of chances when you got to bear down.
Thanks very much. Good luck.
All right, thank you.
Dino Ciccarelli and Joe Micheletti, and the iron coming up big.
Fedorov has not registered a shot on goal through two periods. There you can see he hit the goal post. When you see two members on your team go after one member of another team, somebody's open. And Carpenter here hit the goal post. He's had five shots in the game, more than anybody else. Dino Ciccarelli, he's been around the goal net all game long. And here with a great deflection, a little too fine as the puck went off the crossbar. The Detroit Red Wings have not gotten the offense they're looking for.
Our Bud Ice game summary, Richer, his fifth goal of the playoffs on the power play. Ciccarelli, sixth power play goal of the playoffs, and the shots are 19-12, The Devils have held Detroit to 7 shots in one period and 5 in the other, and that's another thing they just love doing.
Through the playoffs to this point, Detroit, after 2 periods of play in any other game, have averaged 24 shots on goal. That's been cut in half by the Devils with their stifling defensive play, Detroit with only 12. And that's what Dino Ciccarelli was talking about. Not much time, not much space. When you get a chance, you've got to bury it. You've got to get it. So as we start the third period, let's see if anything changes. Primo, by the way, who was one of Detroit's best players in the first half of the game, has not returned for the third period. What a blow that is to Detroit.
No carryover penalties or power plays at the outset of the third period. Paul Coffey, through the first 40 minutes, has played 21 minutes and 20 seconds. He's not out there right now. And the puck comes over to Carpenter, moving out with Richer and Claude Lemieux. Thought Lemieux was headed that way, but he wasn't. Quick change in defense. Albelin and Niedermeyer are on.
And again, the Devils checking line, centered by Bobby Carpenter, with Lemieux and Richer, start the period against Fedorov. Fedorov has not registered a shot through 2 periods. Kozlov has not registered a shot through 2 periods. That's Fedorov's left winger.
Fedorov has had trouble also with faceoffs. He has 1-2 out of 8. Here's Niedermeyer moving in. Tucked a little pass from Neil Broughton. Broughton bumped off by Rouse. Turning with it is Tom Jorski. That one in front that's tapped aside. Given on to Steve Yzerman. Yzerman moving up with McCarty. Shakes one in. The Martin Brodeur is out to play. Struck down by Yzerman. Steve Yzerman twisting around behind. Yzerman with a shot and a save made by Brodeur, and he'll wait. Downstairs now to Joe Micheletti.
Thank you, Mike. 2 areas of concern for the New Jersey Devils. First of all, in that second period, they took 2 bad penalties. That's something that they haven't done throughout the playoffs this year. Number 2, they're concerned about their neutral zone turnovers. Very concerned about the fact that Detroit can pick up the puck and go the other way quickly. Back upstairs to you guys.
Well, it was Steve Yzerman who twisted his way behind that time and got a good opportunity away, but Martin Brodeur didn't give him much, did he?
Steve Yzerman didn't see Doug Brown on the other side of the goal, who was standing there all by himself, and he would have had a tap in. Here's Yzerman. He'll take the shot. Look who's on the left side. Look at Brown over there. Well, that was Brown or Airy, was it? I'm sorry. All by himself waiting for the puck.
Danico cleared it back out and then got out of the way of a hit that was coming from Darren McCarty. Back to Ken Danico again. Coffey to play. Icing will bring the puck all the way back near Mike Vernon. Ken Danico is the owner of a face and a presence on the hockey ice that Ted Lindsay would just love. Ted is here. He's been watching the Red Wings all through these playoffs. He was a tough left winger during the 1950s and 60s, but Ken Danico plays it that way too, with a snarl. 31, 6 feet, 210, and is a part of a trio that have played for the same team for 12 years, the other two on this New Jersey team being Bruce Driver and John McClain.
Danico coming back from a serious knee injury, wears a knee brace. He says he will never take it off again when he plays hockey. He's also one of the dressing room leaders when it's needed in the locker room between periods and such. Danico, a very, very key ingredient to New Jersey.
Bill Guerin turns with it. On now to Sergei Breland, but it's brought back up in a 3-on-2. Draper goes for the return pass that came from Shepard. The Devils just turn it back out. Markow wrists it back in. We had mentioned that there's not been a Detroit championship without a Howe's name on the cup. 4 times it was his father, Gordie. 3 times it was Sid Howe. Twice in the 30s, once in the 40s. Mark hopes this time, the 8th one, it will be him. Played back along by Zelopukin and going back to get it, Constantino. To automatically get your name on the cup, your team must win. You must play 1 game in the finals or 40 in the regular season. The NHL has said that they will prorate that because the season was only 48 games long. We're going to guess that they'll prorate that to 23. But there are also exceptions made in the case of gallant service, which a guy might have been injured and not been able to play the required amount. Play stopped again. 2:29 into the third. But it is the only trophy in which you get your name on the cup, and it stands. And that is another magical ingredient of it.
It really is something magical about it. I know that with Fedorov, he saw a cup one time and he just couldn't believe it. He'd heard so much about it. There's a nice pick play, as you see, by Peluso, knocking his man down, allowing his teammate to handle the puck nicely, actually put it into the stands. Fedorov said he heard about the cup, actually went to an autograph signing session that Gordie Howe was at, and the cup was there at the same time, and he saw it. He saw the people there, and he saw them making a fuss over it. People asked Fedorov to stand beside the cup. That pitch was taken with it. And he started to realize how important it is.
Chambers took his own pass. Sean Chambers checked off. Tursky hooked with a front throw to the backhander, and it's deflected wide. Close call there, and back ahead with it comes Bob Airey. Surrounded by red and black, John McClain will go back to get it. 3 minutes have been played in this third period. Game tied at one. Glad you're watching tonight on Fox. The New Jersey Devils and Detroit Red Wings, best of seven, game one from a sold-out Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Rolled back in by Chorsky. After it is John McClain, and he got there. McClain a shot. Deflected by the defense. Another right. Score! Claude Lemieux! And it is 2-1 in favor of New Jersey.
Claude Lemieux had come off the bench. And the checking line gets the first even-strength goal of the series. Great defensive play by the Devils, closing off the white jerseys. There you see it. Up the ice they come. Now you see the Devils knowing it's a smart time to make a change. Let's make it. As this is going on, the McClain shot, here comes Lemieux off the bench, and it's a rocket past Vernon, who never had a chance to get set on the play. Look at, here comes Lemieux off the bench, way back, trailing. Nobody picks him up. There's the deflection off Coffey and a rocket as Lemieux caught Vernon moving to his left. So it's just New Jersey showing how well they change lines. They make a proper change. Detroit never picked them up, and Lemieux gives his team a go-ahead goal.
Claude Lemieux leads the NHL in playoff goals now with 12. McClain and Chorsky the assists at 3:17. It is normally at this point in the playoffs as well as in regular season when the Devils get the lead that you don't see them being too aggressive offensively. Where do they ever stall you in the neutral ice area then? They really play it conservative. Now whether they'll do that in this one, who knows? Matisse off with a shot that bounced its way over to Fedorov. Fedorov walks right out in front, denied by the poke check of Martin Brodeur. Around it came to Ciccarelli. Dino Ciccarelli controlling for Detroit to the back. One-timer by Patisov, slowed and then kicked. And brought back up by Richer. They hurry, they get a 3-on-2. Alvaline into the play. Stephane Richer fires and a save made by Vernon. Now it's Rouse with under 16 to play in the third period. Little pass ahead on to Chris Draper. Draper with a shot, getting a piece of it, Brodeur. And now a drive by Brown is cut off by Scott Stevens and laid ahead to Chorsky. It's opening up a bit, isn't it? Little pass went away from John McClain and indeed.
And who set up the offense? The Draper. Dino Ciccarelli again with a great pass, and Brodeur with a fine save.
They battle once more. Shaken along to John McClain. Dealt it around behind. Doug Brown takes over there. Brown has spent part of 7 years in the New Jersey organization. Now plays it over to Mark Howe. Back for Konstantinov, but lost, and it's McClain moving in. Brown trying to catch him. McClain around in front, and he wiped out. Whistle, stoppage of play, tripping penalty coming up. A power play to New Jersey. They lead in the game 2-1.
A Detroit turnover leads to a scoring chance. Konstantinov can't handle the puck. Bang! Here comes the puck the other way. Is John McClain on it? Now watch as he pulls the puck to the outside here. He slows down, stops, and then now to the outside he goes away from the defender's stick. Now he cuts to the net, and there's the chop by Brown knocking the feet out of McClain. A crucial power play coming up in this game. Here's Mike Vernon making the play. He's got his stick ready. But the damage was already done by Brown on McClain.
They call that a trip at 4:48. Devils to go on the power play for the third time. They're one for the prior two. And it is Draper. Draper lays it through. Going to get it is Bruce Driver. Driver will be at one point. And the man he just passed to, Sean Chambers. Born in Royal Oak, Michigan, right nearby. Detroit is on the other point as they move it ahead. Breaks down, but it came back over to Freeland. Freeland now around to Bill Guerin. To Chambers, and Guerin again. Bill Guerin dealt it on in. Zelepukin pass. Guerin didn't get much wood on it. Freeland fighting for it, but it's Burr clearing it back out. Shift change for the shorthanded Red Wings. They get Steve Yzerman out now in a penalty-killing role. Chambers step by one, step by two. Sean Chambers moving in. Fetted back. Freeland, a shot that went wide. Rebound turned up against the outside of the net. Played now by Richer. Stephane Richer lays it around behind. Good hit by Konstantinov on Chambers. Aaron battling. Puck came near Richer, but up to Yzerman, and Yzerman flips it back out. 52 for Detroit to kill. Big scoreboard clock above center. Ice winks down to 14 minutes to go in the third. The Devils have the lead on Detroit 2-1. Moving ahead now is Broughton, as down to the ice went McKay. They have to regroup and neutralize. For the Red Wings, it's Airy working along with Sergei Fedorov now. Konstantinov and Lidstrom back on defense. Kicked on back but kept alive by Tommy Albelli. Wrapped around for Randy McKay. McKay checked off, still battling along the wall. Konstantinov clears it off the glove of Albelin and down. Racing down is Draper. Brodeur out of his net. Slides it across to Niedermeyer in the final 15 of the power play. On to Albelin, and then a pass that ricocheted off of Carpenter and is sent back. The Red Wing kill is almost over. Scott Niedermeyer, speedy defenseman for New Jersey, accelerating ahead on Coffey. Niedermeyer got it over to Carpenter. Shot deflected wide by Vernon. He plops the big glove on top of it and play is stopped.
Amazing what speed will do. Niedermeyer gains the blue line with that fantastic speed, avoids the hit here to dump the puck, and now you see the shot by Bobby Carpenter, and yes, Mike Vernon made the save and then hangs on as the puck ricocheted off the backboards.
Downstairs, Joe Micheletti.
Well, bad news for Detroit. Keith Primo is out for the rest of the game. We saw in the second period, he came off holding his right side, went back on the ice for a short shift, got hurt again, came off in a lot of pain. He's now in the hyperbaric chamber, but he's out for the rest of the game. Back to you, Mike.
Boy, big hit by Scott Stevens on him earlier in the game.
And it was from behind. He'd been injured prior to that. The hit by Stevens was from behind, and it had made a whiplash-type motion with the neck and the back. Primo, he then skated right over to the bench and off the ice and has not been back since. What a loss that is.
Matisse off to Airy. Dribbler knocked back along by Carpenter. Chorsky there on Fetisov. Fetisov able to pull away. Fed it back up the boards. May have to get it himself. It's shaken back to Danico. Angled back off behind and taken by Bob Rouse. The veteran defenseman put it off the shank stick of Airy. Danico lifts it right back in again. And around behind, stuck by Vernon. Devils make another change. Bobby Carpenter coming off. Steal by McLean, but it's swept across the goal now. Bob Airy triples one across. Yzerman plays it there. Lays it along Bob Airy, wanting to get by the defense. Right on him is Stevens. Gives him the shoulder, but Airy bounced off. Got it over to Yzerman at the slot. Yzerman, a backhander, knocked down by Danico on defense. Who's cut behind? Yzerman has it again. Yzerman put it off the back of the goal, and it's held there by Brodeur. Play is stopped from Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. 2-1 Devils, the Stanley Cup Final. Next Saturday night, 8 o'clock Eastern, Game 4. Red Wings and Devils at the Meadowlands Arena in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Tonight, Game 1, third period. A lot of noise at Joe Louis Arena. 2-1, the Devils ahead of the Red Wings, and here's Fedorov turning with it. Sergei Fedorov, a pass. Kozlov turns with it. Shoots one, blocked by Brodeur, and he covers. And play is stopped.
Mike, on that play, Brown took the faceoff as opposed to Fedorov. Fedorov's had problems with a bad shoulder. He's wearing bigger shoulder pads to try and protect it. Watch Brown lose a stick here as Broughton just reaches it right out of his hands. But still, Detroit battles for the loose puck and find a way with Fedorov leading the charge to get the puck towards the goal. Brown skates to the corner to get his own stick back. Fedorov can't take draws. It's one reason I think he's not doing well on them is because of that bad shoulder.
It is Broughton lobbing it back in. Mike Vernon plays it on the bounce. Detroit's goalkeeper handing it on over. Play to be made back now to Sergei Fedorov. In his shadow is Kozlov as the trailer. Fedorov with a shot off of Brodeur. Swept back. And it'll have to be played and neutralized by Mark Howe.
Fedorov gets a shot. It's a bad angle shot, but he made sure he hit the net. His forwards, his teammates, have to drive to the net to try to find a rebound. There's not much open space for a head-on shot. You have to find rebounds.
Kozlov ahead. Hands on to Paul Coffey. Coffey turning away from Driver, but lost to Niedermeyer. Niedermeyer hit by a pair. Puck back up to Randy McKay. Kept alive by Lidstrom. Forced away from him and sent further. But it's McKay walking it back ahead. Randy McKay out of Michigan Tech trying to get by. McKay around behind the net with it now. Oh, a leaping attempt at hit by Dino Ciccarelli. Missed. Back down to the point. Albelina shot. Save, Vernon. He covers. Oh, play stopped.
All that play, four-on-four action, and you say, what? Nobody in the penalty box. Coffey and Niedermeyer were wrestling behind Brodeur's goal net during the entire time while the puck was in the Detroit zone. Here's the puck as Niedermeyer gets hammered. Now Coffey stays in there, and they get wrapped up with one another, and they stay there, and they wrestle, and they stay with one another. And at the other end of the ice, there's goal-scoring chances going on. Lemieux and Brown. Some more waltzing. Oh, a little right cross by Brown. Lemieux took his man. Here's the scoring chance as the players are now trying to get back over center ice. You see Niedermeyer and Coffey coming back. Another deflection as Vernon makes the fine save.
And we still have 11 minutes to go, and maybe more.
And I think you'll see Coffey try to join the offense even more so now with his team trailing under 11 minutes to go.
Ciccarelli again from 90 feet wide. A check. Jocelyn Law. Shepard battling again and a three-man behind.
Ciccarelli's lost his centerman to Keith Primeau. And here's Sean Burr getting a shift at center ice. He's not nearly as quick as Primeau.
Angled back in. Sergei Freeland up with it. Freeland around behind. Wants to get a wrap around. Can't do it. Locked aside by Vernon. Made back ahead by the Red Wings. Freeland stepping into Ciccarelli. Guerin hit from behind by Burr. Red Wings getting some muscle in here. Niedermeyer hands it across to Tommy Alberley. Then a pass on to Bill Guerin. That's onside. Guerin cranks a shot. Save made by Vernon. Rebound. Rotten couldn't get a shot away. Stepped into by Rouse. Tom Chorsky turns away. Getting some time to Stevenson drive. And it got the glass past the shrugging goaltender. The plane was won. The triple wide. Turned around by Danico. Cut played by Fetisov. And it's brought back up again by Sean Burr with Ciccarelli. Little pass for him. Ciccarelli couldn't get it by Scott Stevens. Oh, and Burr stepped into him. And it's Fetisov in neutral ice. Slava Fetisov, a veteran of three Olympics for the then Soviet Union. Two goals and a silver. Ahead now with it is Stevens. On for Carpenter. Eaten up by Vernon. Sweeps it aside over to Bob Arum. 24 shots to 16. The Devils with the advantage. They lead in the game. You can see in the upper left, 2-1. You see the time remaining as Fedorov walks it back out, gives it on for Steve Yzerman. Yzerman wedged off. McLean rammed high and hard by Konstantinov. It's on to Bobby Carpenter. Watched by Mark Howe, and Howe able to deny him. Passed on around for Bob Airey to play again. Mark Howe, 22-year pro hockey player. Howe walking it ahead, lays a pass on the money. Across two lines to Bob Airey. Play stopped at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit.
Here's what the Devils do best. Look at all three players looking this way, forcing the puck up that way. Here comes Detroit. See the pass now. There they converge on the man in white. Turnover. Detroit gets the puck, but all their offense is standing still. So that's how Jersey stops the offensive flow of other teams, even the great skating team like Detroit.
Zelopukin got away from the check of Eisen, got away from the check of Konstantinov, and flipped one off the back of the net. Still working, but it's held and play is stopped.
A lot of criticism about New Jersey and their style of play and defensive and sit back. They haven't sat back here. They've had the 2-1 lead, yet they're forcing the play here. And they're making sure if Detroit sets up to come out of their zone, then they'll back up a little bit and be tentative until a neutral zone. But since Detroit hasn't had a chance to get control of the puck, they're playing it hard, and they're going for that third goal as opposed to sitting and trying to win it 2-1. Detroit has not been able to stimulate their offense, to get their flow going, to get the fans into it. New Jersey is masterful at taking fans out of a game.
They are quiet here, aren't they? Yzerman could bring them out of their seats, and here is Steve Yzerman around behind, and a sliding play by Sean Chambers stopped that loose puck. They go for it, and it came to John McLean. Starts out in a 3-on-2, picks up Bruce Driver. It is McLean going wide. John McLean trying to center, denied by Mark Howe. Strong defensive effort by Howe tonight. Konstantinov with a pass ahead. Yzerman denied for a moment. Crunch at center ice, and the puck to Chambers, and right back in its rifle. Clock ticks down now to 8 minutes to go in the third. Mark Howe, two skating defenseman, with a pass on now to the turning Doug Brown. Now again, off of Fedorov and Niedermeyer to Alvelin and right back in again.
It has not been a defensive pairing for New Jersey against Fedorov. It's been this Bobby Carpenter, Claude Lemieux, Stephane Richer line.
Here's Fedorov moving in. Got it over for a shot by Brown that's tipped wide. Big drive by Kozlov. And that one ricochets into the second tier. Play stopped. Still 2-1 New Jersey. Play back in. The decisive goal by Claude Lemieux from McLean and Chorsky at 3:17, which broke the tie. May not be the last goal, though. Icing call.
And here we have Scotty Bowman putting Dino Ciccarelli on the ice in right on the right wing position with Fedorov and Kozlov, along with Coffey, the best offensive defenseman to get offense. Throw Lidstrom in there, the other defenseman, and you've got five quality offensive people on the ice right now at once. Brown's the usual right winger. He's been taken off. And there's the coaching staff trying to figure out what to do. No Keith Primeau due to injury. They're leaning on Fedorov and Yzerman at the center ice position to get it done for them.
Bobby Carpenter won it cleanly from Fedorov and then takes the return pass but gave it up. Follow-up though comes from Scott Niedermeyer, nudges on to Claude Lemieux. Lemieux with a shot blocked away by Vernon. Fedorov with one shot on goal in the game. Primeau with one, and he's injured, will not be back. Yzerman with two shots. Lidstrom cancel. Sergei Fedorov bringing it ahead in a three-on-three. Fedorov through the legs. Kozlov with a shot. Deflected block. Tapped on back. John McClain hustles to it for New Jersey. Lays a pass too far for Chorsky. Brushed aside by Rout. Slava Kutizov controlling for the Detroit defense. Gets it back from Fedorov, then plays it ahead on the wing. Rout drives it back in. Another shift change for Detroit. 6.5 to go. Tipped off of Chorsky. Tom Chorsky nudges it along to John McClain. McClain spun it further, but it's Draper. So again, Fetisov. Freeland, Mike Peluso, and Randy McKay. Not noticed Bobby Holik since the first period.
Here he comes now as Freeland finished his shift, so the crash line on the ice as a unit for New Jersey.
Scott Stevens. Big hit on him, but he recovered to play it up the board. Andy McKay able to flip it back. Not now becoming the enemy of the Red Wings. 5:50 to go. It is only one goal that they need to get it even. Danico had it taken away by Shepard and a feed over to the turning Chris Draper. Draper, good one in front, unable to get a shot away with Brown, and then one ricocheted off Stevens, and it's a 2-on-1. Mark Howe is back. Bringing it up is Stevens. He's got Peluso and fires, and a save made by Vernon. And play is stopped again.
Konstantinov moved in, the defenseman. The offense didn't work for Detroit. And all of a sudden, Big Scott Steven pops out, and it's instant offense for New Jersey. Here you see everybody in the white jersey inside the top of the circles. And here comes Stevens. Four jerseys caught deep by Detroit. 2-on-1. Konstantinov hustled here. And the shot on goal. Detroit's had 16 shots. Only four here in the third period, and none in the last 4 minutes as they try and try and try to find a way. It was a good, hard, long shot. Stevens didn't get fancy, knowing that if he made a pass or turned the puck over as a defenseman, he would have been caught. That was a smart play just to take the shot.
6-2 in odd man rushes. Those are 2-on-1s, 3-on-2. Scott Stevens just led a 2-on-1.
I don't think the six is amazing for Detroit. I think the two is, or pardon me, for New Jersey. The two is for Detroit, knowing that they're fast, they explode with offense when they're on a roll. But New Jersey, they just continue. Jacques Lemaire, their coach, said he was so happy with the way that they practiced 2 days prior to this game. He could see it in their eyes, the focus, the concentration. He said earlier in the season, they couldn't make two passes in a row some days. He knew they weren't going to play well. He expected them to play well here, and they have to this point.
Big hit by Zelopukin freed the puck. Lidstrom tries the other way. Darren McCarty has it. McCarty's pass tipped out of play, and so again the clock stopped.
It was a bad break. Coffey wanted the puck to jump into the offense. The puck went into the stands.
As we come back, another puck shot up into the seats with 5:06 to go in the third period. Devils have quieted the big crowd of 19,875. Devils have the lead over the Red Wings 2-1. Now, would you knowingly bring a hat like that? Yeah, I guess he did.
Well, here it's fine, but I wouldn't want to wear it to work.
If they bring seafood in, I guess they bring the hat.
Scotty Bowman using Coffey and Lidstrom with Eisenman's line and Fedorov's line playing to generate offense.
Aaron McCarty drops back further, hands it over to Paul Coffey. Coffey's pass is spirited right back on and sent in by Eisenman. Brodeur to drive. John McClain taken away by Paul Coffey. Couldn't get it centered. Coffey nearly got to the front, but it was knocked away by Driver. Give it up to Eisenman. And a shot! Got the glass! He tried for the top right, and it was too high. That'll continue. Puck over to Chorsky. Along the rail to Bob Aaron. Couldn't center because of Chambers. Chambers tries the other way. Really hit for his trouble. Coffey kept it alive. Along the line, it's an onside play. But it comes over to Chorsky. They've got another two-on-one. Chorsky moving in with John McClain. Chorsky's pass is deflected high by Lidstrom. Solid defensive play there by Nicholas Lidstrom. Keeps this a 2-1 New Jersey lead with four to go. Here comes Fedorov. Devils moving on him. Puck taken over by Claude Lemieux.
Ciccarelli stays on the ice with Fedorov's line now to get offense.
Vernon eats that shot up. Gets it behind, but Lemieux there and tucked a pass in front. Ciccarelli's pass. Deflected away by Carpenter. They battle it on with it to Sean Burr. Trying for it, Fedorov, but it's swept right back down again.
Detroit had had their best forecheck shift of the period. The Eisenman line was out there. But all of a sudden, New Jersey gets a 2-on-1. The story of their game.
Fedorov again. Pursued from behind. Goes down once more. Niedermeyer sent it further. Matisse off with it there. Off of Ciccarelli. Niedermeyer again. That's over for Albany. Jacques Lemaire has said, when you make the opponent uncomfortable, you own them. The ownership is not totally decided yet, but the style of play is definitely what New Jersey has wanted. And here is Broughton again, moving in with Tom Chorsky. The pass went off Matisse off. Chorsky curling around behind. Tucks it over for McClain, but he was checked by Draper. Back up with it come the Red Wings, moving on to Sean Burr. Moving in is Brown, and a shot deflected wide by Danico. Draper couldn't get a shot away. Sent up the boards by Scott Stevens. And striding back to get it is Vladimir Konstantinov. Check that, Ray Shepard. Shepard with a pass on to Coffey. And steered ahead for Brown again. Draper trying to return it to Brown, but it skips to Stevens. Stevens ran. Puck turned over. Back it comes to Draper. Shoots one. Knocked down by the defense. Played by Bobby Holik. Tries to get it going the other way. That failed. Holik still batting at it. Stevens run off. Draper hurries it back to Coffey. Flipped one that's blocked aside by Brodeur. Chopped along by Stevens. Pinching along is Lidstrom, and now he has it. Lidstrom looks. Shoots one that's blocked down by Peluso. Draper couldn't come up with it. Clock ticking down now to just over 2 minutes to play.
Almost 7 minutes of play without Detroit registering a shot on goal. That's how good this New Jersey club has been defensively. Give them full marks for it.
And play is stopped at neutral ice with 1:50 left.
And you can really see how important Keith Primeau is to the Detroit Red Wing Hockey Club. They are different without him.
Opener of the best of seven Stanley Cup final, 2-1. Slava Fetisov controlling, hands on to Mark Howe. Howe sends it around. Brodeur stops it there. Driver shoots it around. Eisenman kept it there. Eisenman couldn't battle his way through Driver. Driver lost it to Eisenman again. Steve Eisenman, nice control. Eisenman heading around behind. Gets away from the dive and then is hit. It's thrown back off again by Chambers. Mike Vernon had come all the way out past the hash marks as he was headed off the ice for an extra attacker, a risk that they're ready to take. Fetisov dumps it in. Vernon is out near the blue line and now is headed to the bench. John McClain up with it, turned it to center ice, and the extra man from the bench was right there, Shepard. Drank back in again by Fetisov, but it ricocheted off McClain. Fetisov again, scales it back in deep. John Chambers goes to get it. 52 seconds to go, the net empty at the other end of the ice. Chorsky flips one, skipped off of Ciccarelli and played a neutral ice by Lidstrom. Then long to Kozlov, put it off a leg, and it flies to into the corner. Passed around behind. Ciccarelli got it over to Fedorov. Down the last 36. Threw one in front. Blocked down by Brodeur. Rebound. He fouled out. And cleared it away. Coffey shoots one. That hit a leg. Played now by Fedorov. Tried to work it around, but it's Chambers. Pressing it around further. Komsorgsky goes to it. Right there to get it at Kozlov. Kozlov over to Coffey with 20 to go. Wrist shot. Blocked down by the defense. Sean Chambers playing it there. And McLean flies it back down the ice. This trip will go back to get it. No icing here. Clock ticks down to the last 10. Detroit's got to hurry. Tipped along by Fedorov. Guided back by Lemieux. Kozlov on with it. 3 to go. Kozlov nudges one wide. Shepard goes to get it. And the horn sounds, and New Jersey has won the first game, and a scrap breaks out after the horn between Kozlov and Lemieux.
New Jersey, with their ninth road win of the playoffs, continue. They gave Detroit one shot on goal in the last 8 minutes, 54 seconds of this third period. Astonishing defense.
Detroit trudges off. The beaten team, the Devils, celebrate winning 2-1. We'll be right back. Final score of the game, the Devils 2, the Red Wings 1. Claude Lemieux was feisty right to the final horn and then some. And he is our player of the game by Jeep. Jeep is proud to donate $1,000 in Lemieux's name to the Amateur Hockey Association of his choice. The final score, the Devils 2, the Red Wings 1. The Devils lead the best of 7-1-0. You'll hear from James Brown in just a moment.
So the New Jersey Devils take game one of the Stanley Cup Finals by the score of 2-1. And since the best of seven format was implemented back in 1931, teams winning game one have won the cup 44 of 56 times. Detroit's got a tough road to go.
Well, they sure do have a tough road to go. And the Devils did exactly what they have to do. They are not a team that's going to attack. They create. Detroit blink first.
All right, folks. So we will join you next Saturday in the Meadowlands. For everyone here at Fox Sports, I'm James Brown. We'll see you next week.
Gone by far, and the Red Wings have waited long enough. They haven't won a cup in 40 years, haven't been in one since 8 years before the Devils franchise was created in Kansas City in 1974. New Jersey has rode the gifted goaltending of Martin Brodeur to its first final. Detroit is a dominating 12-2 this postseason and has lost only 13 times all year. It's the first time two teams who didn't meet all season are playing for the cup. The Devils' first look at the octopi. And the big one that hangs over Joe Louis Arena and the ghosts of Wings past. Howe, Abel, Lindsay, looking for the first cup since the mid-50s. The blast on Vernon from Bobby Holík. The save by Vernon. But on the power play with Bill Guerin in the penalty box, Cicero to Iserman. Deflects off the crossbar, still scoreless. Red Wings keep up the pressure. Primo around the net, feeds Cicerelli, who has been so powerful in this postseason. Scoreless after one. Second period, Stephane Richer. The shot from the circle, Vernon got a piece, but take another look. Richer gets his fifth postseason goal, trickles right through the five hole, and it's 1-0 visitors. Wings in the power play goal. Cicerelli puts in the ricochet. He has been dominant on the power play. His ninth PP in the postseason ties it at one. Late second, Devils hitting takes its toll. Scott Stevens hits Primo. He's out for the game in the second period. Still 1-1 to the third. Tom Troisky, the bank off the boards. McLean chases it down. And then Claude Lemieux, who had just 6 goals in the regular season, now has 12 in the playoffs. Close it up, Mike Ilitch. Jersey continues its dominance on the road. They're 9-1 the postseason away from the Meadowlands. It's the first postseason home loss by the Wings, who will get a chance to even things up on Tuesday in the second game. They got off just 17 shots on Brodeur. Only one got by. We will have much more from Joe Louis Arena later on in SportsCenter, including reaction as the Devils have taken a 2-1 first game win.
You scores the game winner in the third. Right now, let's head to Detroit and join Steve Levy.
The New Jersey Devils clearly have a formula for success, and that is to score the first goal in the game, trap their opponent to death the rest of the way, and then win on the road. And joining me is Bruce Driver, one of the lifelong career Devils. This has to be very special for you.
Well, it's definitely a big win for us. There's no doubt about that. It was a tight checking game for both teams. I mean, as evident, the score 2-1, but Neither team was given much at all, and fortunately we were able to get the second goal.
All right, quickly on the three items. 14 of the 17 playoff games, you guys have scored the first goal, the trap everyone's talking about, and winning on the road, you set an NHL record, their ninth road win in these playoffs. What about it?
Well, we've just been very successful in sticking with our game. I mean, a lot of people are making noise about the trap, and basically what we try to do is force the puck as much as possible. We want to forecheck as aggressively as much as we can. Sometimes we can't get in the offensive zone to forecheck with two guys, so our only idea there is not get caught. And, whereas you see most teams always have one guy high, one guy back, when we can't forecheck, we make sure we got two guys back.
All right, don't want to make too much out of shots on goal, but in the playoffs, Detroit had averaged 36 shots on goal. You held them to less than half that. As a defenseman, you got to feel good about that.
Well, I'll tell you, we blocked a lot of shots. Our defense got in front of some shots. Our forwards did as well. They had a post and a crossbar as well, so, it very easily could have gone the other way.
All right, for you and John McClain and Ken Danica, we kind of talked about it before the game. These are special times. You mentioned in pro sports how many teams have three lifelong players like yourselves. It's got to be a terrific time.
Well, there's no doubt. We're thrilled to be here. It's been a long time coming, and, like I said, this is only game one. It gets tougher from here.
All right, we'll see you game two Tuesday. Thanks.
Thanks, Steve.
All right, Bruce Driver of the New Jersey Devils now joining me, ESPN hockey analyst Barry Melrose. And I couldn't ask it to Bruce, but I think the rest of the country is going to be shocked. The Devils come on the road and win to open up this series playing Jersey Devils hockey.
Well, I don't think they should be shocked. I think this shows what kind of team the Devils have, how good they are. They match up very well. The one thing I am shocked about, and you mentioned it with Bruce, is the 17 shots against by Detroit. This is a high-powered offense. They got talented men on every line. And to hold a team like that, even if you block 10 shots, is unbelievable, 17 shots. So I think the people saw tonight what kind of team the Devils have.
All right, Jersey has been the underdog throughout and feeling almost like the battered child of the two. However, not taking anything away from them, Keith Primo was the best player for Detroit in the first two periods, did not play in the third due to injury. Looked like it took a lot away from the Red Wings.
It took an unbelievable amount away from the Red Wings. Keith is the one guy who's big and physical enough to knock the defenseman around, knock Stevens around, knock Danico around. And in the first period, he was doing that. Detroit had a lot of chances. Bruce mentioned that they hit the crossbar and hit the post. One of them was off something Primo created. Without him, they don't forecheck as hard. They're not as dangerous when they forecheck. Ciccarelli, as hard as he works, he can't do the damage physically as a Keith Primo can. And Keith Primo plays 25 minutes a night for Detroit. So that injury is paramount. If Keith Primo's hurt for any length of time, that's going to really damage Detroit's chances in this series.
All right, 2 days off in this series, and then game two resumes back here at Joe Louis on Tuesday night. Let's go back to SportsCenter.
Thank you, Steve. And right here on the network, you can see Game 2 of the Stanley Cup Finals live at 8 Eastern, Tuesday night from Detroit.
Yeah, well, they got a great team, and they come at you pretty hard. The first period, they came at us really hard. But, as I said, we stay patient. We play four lines. We go, make the right plays. We were mentally sharp, get the puck in deep, try and not let them get wound up in the neutral zone. And that was the key tonight. And everybody made a tremendous effort. And, of course, we got Big Marty back there kicking the puck out, and that helps a lot.
You guys will be overconfident for game two, I'm sure.
No, we never get overconfident. I mean, we know we were fortunate tonight to get a win. Anytime you get a win on the road, it's great. But, we're going to come out. We'll enjoy this one this evening. But come Tuesday, we'll be ready to play just as hard.
All right, Devils continue to win on the road. 2 days off before game two, Tuesday, back here at Joe Louis. Let's go back to SportsCenter.